हा येते 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 येते.
ओके ओके
बरं, एक टेस्ट घ्यायची आहे थोडीशी, एक मिनिटात आवाज येतोय आम्हाला.
बर बर, एक सेकंड मी प्रेझेंटेशन उघडू.
हो हो, फक्त एकदा चेक करून घेऊ एक मिनिटासाठी.
हो
सर, मैंने प्रेजेंटेशन शेयर करने का राइट्स दे दिए.
ओके आ गया प्रेजेंटेशन.
यस सर, ओके, डन.
ओके,
यस, मिनिमाइज कर दीजिए सर.
You can just close the sharing right now and redo it.
Close.
Mukul Tyagi sir bhi online aa gaye hain.
Tyagi sir.
Ji, ji sir.
Sir, 2 baj gaye, shall we start?
Haan sir, start kar do. Haan.
Pehle mera number hai kya?
Ji sir.
Okay.
सचिन सर, यू कैन स्टार्ट.
नमस्कार सबको.
नमस्ते सर.
सबको नमस्कार. आज का जो वेबिनार है अपना, इनोवेशंस इन वर्टिकल फार्मिंग एंड बिजनेस अपॉर्चुनिटीज, इंडियन नर्सरी एसोसिएशन और इस ऑर्गेनाइज वेबिनार में आप सभी का मैं स्वागत करता हूं. आज के इस वेबिनार में हमारे जो दो स्पीकर्स है, बारपांडे साहब, प्रदीप बारपांडे साहब और प्रसन्ना मूर्ति साहब, इन दोनों का इंडियन नर्सरी मैन एसोसिएशन की ओर से तहे दिल से स्वागत. आज हमारे इंडियन नर्सरी मैन एसोसिएशन के सेक्रेटरी मुकुल त्यागी भी साथ हमारे साथ जुड़े हुए. त्यागी साहब, आपका भी स्वागत. और जो भी आज हमारे पार्टिसिपेंट्स है, जो आज वर्टिकल गार्डन्स और फार्मिंग जो अपॉर्चुनिटीज ढूंढ रहे और बिजनेस अपॉर्चुनिटीज ढूंढ रहे, इनके लिए अच्छे से एक बेंचमार्क और अच्छा एक बैसपीड है आज. मुझे इसमें कोई दोहरा और शंका नहीं है कि आज का वेबिनार इन सबके लिए बहुत उपयुक्त साबित होगा. तो सभी पार्टिसिपेंट्स का फिर से एक बार तहे दिल से स्वागत. इंडियन नर्सरी एसोसिएशन काफी इस तरह से मेहनत ले रहा है और नर्सरी मैन स्टूडेंट्स और सभी के बारे तक पहुंचने की कोशिश कर रहा है कि जिससे हमारा नॉलेज बने, इनोवेटिव आइडियाज बने और इससे हम हमारे फील्ड में जो काम कर रहे हैं इसमें अपग्रेड हो पाए. तो उसी तरह से आज हमारे पास जो पहले हमारे स्पीकर है प्रदीप बारपांडे साहब, वेरी इनोवेटिव एंड क्रिएटिव पर्सन, इनकी मेरे पास शब्द नहीं है कि इनकी इंट्रोडक्शन के लिए कि इतने इनोवेटिव पर्सन हमारे आज साथ में है, जिनका बेसिक क्वालिफिकेशन चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट है, चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट, लेकिन जो आज उन्होंने इनोवेशन और क्रिएटिविटी यूज करके आज वर्टिकल गार्डन में एक नाम बनाया है, नॉट ऑल ओवर इंडिया बट आई विल से कि अब्रॉड में भी इनका एक अच्छा सा एक सेटअप चल नाम है. तो जो उनका इतने साल का एक्सपीरियंस और तजुर्बा है वो हमारे सभी आज के जो भी पार्टिसिपेंट्स है उनको जरूर काम आएगा. ज्यादा समय न लेते हुए प्रदीप पारपांडे सर से रिक्वेस्ट करता हूँ कि ही वी कैन स्टार्ट हिज प्रेजेंटेशन. सो प्रदीप पारपांडे सर.
ओके, थैंक यू एवरीवन, गुड आफ्टरनून. सर ने बताया, एक्चुअली आई एम कीन observer of plant growth and of course I like doing new things and take a risk for that. So actually that is one of the reason why we have achieved what we have till now. Today's topic is basically technology related to vertical gardens, innovation and practicability. So you know, excitement mein koi kuch करने का सोच लेता है लेकिन इट डजंट वर्क. सो बेसिकली उसके पीछे साइंस क्या है, वो काम कैसे करता है, ये देखने के बाद ही एक्चुअली कोई अलग ढंग का काम हो सकता है। अभी दुनिया में क्या चल रहा है ये हमें देखना बहुत जरूरी है। ये जो प्रोजेक्ट है ये बिग आर्किटेक्ट्स करके है, ये है ताइवान में, इसमें एक पार्ट सैंपल जो है वो हो चुका है। यू कैन सी इट इज 100% इनोवेटिव डिजाइन रिक्वायरिंग इनोवेटिव सॉल्यूशंस। सिर्फ डिजाइन इनोवेटिव होके कुछ नहीं होता है, वो एक्चुअली एग्जीक्यूट करने के लिए सही टीम की भी जरूरत होती है, सही सिस्टम की जरूरत होती है, टेक्नोलॉजी, नो हाउ, पर्सनल, एवरीथिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड। दिस प्रोजेक्ट इज ऑफ लेट ज़ाहा हदीद, वर्ल्ड नोन आर्किटेक्ट। दिस प्रोजेक्ट इज इन सैन फ्रांसिस्को। दिस वॉज एक्चुअली अ बस स्टैंड विच वॉज कन्वर्टेड इन टू अ फोर स्टोरीड बिल्डिंग विथ मेट्रो, मॉल, टू फ्लोर्स, अ गार्डन एंड बस टर्मिनल्स। दिस इज हाउ इट इज नाउ। इट हैड बेसिकली ऑल द प्लांट्स वेर प्री ग्रोन एंड दे वेर प्लांटेड। दिस इज ज्वेल चांगी एयरपोर्ट लेटेस्ट टर्मिनल। Everybody knows, everybody has seen this, at least on the photographs. The earlier terminal, T3. This is Garden by Bay. So, when we look at all these credits, basically we understand that sky is the limit for innovation. And when technology support this kind of designs, you get to see something marvelous like this. Is it happening only in foreign countries? No. Actually, this YouTube is available on YouTube, and you can see how our Bangalore, India's first biophilic terminal is going to come. It's in process. Elaborate landscape, hanging gardens, green walls, indoor gardens. So basically this project is going to set a benchmark for Indian landscape, probably in the world itself. This could be the first of its kind because of not only the design, but intention to provide the best of the world to this airport. Now, are we ready? Are we able to? So see, these are some of the projects which have taken place in India. This is 7 years old. This is 1 week old. Okay, this is 1 week old. This is 7 years old. This is 2.5 years old. So we are basically capable of delivering this kind of projects. Now, this also tells us that we have this kind of opportunities, but how to catch these opportunities? We have seen, we normally see many more plants dying on the different kind of green walls, on the roads, in the landscape. So that should not discourage us from doing innovations, basically. So this is a very simple garden, you can see. It doesn't require much technology. But with right kind of media, understanding light intensity, one is able to deliver this biophilic space to the client. Simple garden. So how do we achieve this world-class effect? What does this vertical gardening involve? It involves architecture, it involves engineering, it involves product design, plant selection, growth media engineering, smart irrigation, proactive maintenance, safety with warranty. So, you know, a designer can always design as per his ability, I would say. This project is designed by Borrega Farnell Studio from Singapore. It appears very simple, but if you look at the curvatures, sloping edges, cutouts, tilted surfaces, then you will notice that it's not so easy to execute. So engineering helps in this point. You can see this is a curved surface which is treated very well, the fabrication design, fabrication as such. Everything has enabled making these curvatures. So engineering is required. Even you have to calculate the load factors. And only after that, you are able to reach to next level of greenery. You have to select right kind of system. What system will work for my project is something which one has to decide. There are n number of products available in the market. Each of the system has its own advantages. But when you are doing something as per the, if a client or designer gives you a particular kind of preview or his expected view of the project, that after that you have to decide, what do I want? See, this is where, due to very high wind velocity, green wall got damaged. So one has to understand what kind of loads are there, wind loads are there, self load is there, positive and negative wind velocity. So all these things are to be considered when we decide which product, which structure we are using. So this is Nizamuddin Bridge in Delhi. So few months back, due to cyclone, out of 4 bridges, 1 bridge was damaged a lot. It had a highest wind velocity, and because of the blockage of the wind, it suffered the most. The other 2 bridges, rather 3 bridges, I would say, didn't have so much because even the system was allowing air to pass through. So, you know, you have to understand different forces, natural forces, which are going to affect. It can be temperature, it can be wind velocity, and so on. We are going to discuss it in elaborate manner after this. So whenever we are doing shallow plantation for green walls and green roofs, we actually provide 6 inch maximum, 4 to 6 inch depth of soil. For vertical gardens, 4 inch maximum, 5 inch. So the root anchorage becomes very difficult in that case because there is no space for tap roots to grow, and nor we expect, nor we want them to grow too much. Otherwise, coiling of roots happen. So what we do, we have to provide a mechanical anchorage. And this anchorage can be done through providing geotextile. You can have a foam, you can have a perforated member, mesh, and so on. So once you provide root anchorage to a plant, even though it is in shallow media, it stops shaking and the evaporation, that is dehydration, doesn't take place. So root anchorage is very important. You have to provide it mechanically in this case of vertical gardens and shallow green roofs. Again, because of the shallow roots, lesser volume of the media, one has to make sure that the plant requires, the quantum of moisture required by a plant is provided. It cannot happen that my modules are smaller, my planting cavities are smaller. So plants will suffer, especially in North India. You are having temperatures up to 48 degrees. And at 48 degrees, even if plant is not provided water at right time, you will see scorching. Shoot system, if it is scorched, maybe after next irrigation, it will come up. But if root zone gets damaged, then plants suffer and there are very less chances of reviving. So providing sufficient moisture within module, within planting cavities is very important. So the best way is to provide water reservoirs in the module itself. So it is a part of design of the module. So when you select a product, you have to think about its secure fastening. You have to think about its root anchorage. You have to think about water holding and all that. Plant selection is done on the basis of climate, microclimate, design inputs, orientation of green wall, shade path, access frequency available, and maintenance capability of the staff. So something, you know, for normally for climatic restrictions, rather limitations, a plant which is suitable in Kerala may not be suitable in Delhi. There are a number of reasons for that. It's not just temperature. It can be even the moisture level in combination with the temperature. So different climatic conditions attract different kind of problems and poses different kind of challenges. So one has to understand the plants which are good for particular climatic zone. Then comes microclimate. There are many microclimatic factors. I believe there is another slide after this. But microclimate is also very important. Same places in Delhi, two locations can have a different microclimate. So it is site specific, and the plant selection is also site specific. Design inputs from designer. If a client, if a designer wants more naturalistic plants popping out and where, you know, like ferns, grasses, that kind of thing, then you have to select the right system which will be able to provide that kind of plant palette, support the, that kind of plant palette. There are some systems which are very good for, say, manicured garden. They give clean single look or maybe a single level look, and some overgrow and then they cover. So depending on the design inputs, one has to decide which system is suitable to suitable for the project. Orientation of green wall and shade path. this is most important of the all of this. It's more because, you know, till say Maharashtra, even little part of Ahmedabad, as you go up, there is a covered, there is a cloud cover after say May end, after 10th April or so, we start getting some clouds. After by 15th May, we have a good cover. And because of the moisture in the air and the cloud cover, we our plants on north side, they are protected. But this doesn't happen in Delhi. Till 22nd June, you may or may not have cloud cover. Also, the same direction, same side, is going to face shade when it is cold. During winter, it is going to have a shade for almost 1.5 months if it is exact north. And then the south side will get shade all the time. North side will get shade all the time for 1.5 months time. So a plant which has to sustain 48 degrees temperature and also it has to sustain a 1 degree with shade varying. So this plant selection plays a very important role on the basis of orientation. There could be a salt spray near the sea. It can, if there could be a high wind velocity situation. So all these things one has to understand first. And on the basis of that, one has to select plant. One may not have a large palette for a particular situation. You may have 3-4 plants doing well, and you will have to play with that only. So, you know, it's not what a madam likes or what boss likes. It is what, it's more important what plants like. If you provide what plants like, then only you are going to have nice looking green walls and vegetation. Access frequency is also very important. When we work on, you know, high green walls, maybe 10 floors. After second floor, once you cannot work with ladder, you need a good access. It can be cradle, it can be scaffolding, it can be a cherry picker. And all those options one has to actually provide in advance. And on the basis of availability of access, one has to select the plants. Plants which require a lot of maintenance, one cannot actually use them in the area where you have lesser frequency. So something like, you know, on a facade, normally, you know, for this particular kind of hydraulic platforms, they have a limitation of 39 feet or 45 feet. Above that, they don't go. In this particular case, now just there is a case in Delhi itself. Our green wall is 55 feet tall, and the platform reaches up to 45 feet. So the area above that, one has to select plants which require very less access. Just take case of Zed plant. That plant is so nice for lazy people that you don't need to go up and do the maintenance for 3 months, 4 months. So there we have to use a spider that is who does window washing. We have trained him and we were doing that maintenance through him. So access frequency also decides what plant I am supposed to use. Now maintenance capability. You know, in cities, it is easy to get trained people, but this doesn't happen. All the farmhouses around Delhi and all big cities, a person takes 4 hours, 3 hours to reach those places. So if you are going to keep challenges for him for maintenance, then this is not going to happen. Someday green wall is going to die. Plants are going to die. Whether it's a green wall, whether it's a green roof or even landscape. So having a plantation or vegetation planned on the basis of ability of a staff is also very important. So plant selection, is, as I said, is not somebody's liking. It is a liking in between the plant palette suitable for the project. So this is for understanding microclimate. So basically light intensity, availability and duration of light is important. It changes with Dakshinayana and Uttarayana. With that, you know, the sun path one has to understand. There is a case in Mumbai.
Over there.
How can we stop them? Okay. So in Mumbai, it is a T-shaped building. And our building is maybe, let me check if I have that photograph. I will explain with that slide. But availability, understanding availability of light, its seasonal change and its intensity is something which is very important. And that you will understand only after you go to the site. Simulation of the building and simulation of the known things is possible. But if there is a gulmohar tree planted 1 year back, this year it doesn't have a lot of too many leaves, but in next 3 years, next 2 years, it's going to give coverage. So understanding these factors like features of landscape and all that, one has to understand only by going to the site. Then, you know, fireplace, water body, chimney, salt spray, all these factors are also to be considered. And that you will understand once you visit the site. So the site visit and the list of things to be checked on site is to be done in a first visit so that you are able to arrive at some feasibility. You will know whether this is possible, this is not possible. Okay. Wind velocity, industrial establishments causing pollution, solid or maybe hazardous gases. Dust, others. Water quality is also important. There are some plants which can take hard water. There are some plants which can take very acidic water. But what is challenging is our irrigation system taking this water. So you may have recycled water or treated water, or you may have this STP water, which keeps on changing its quality. No offense, I have experienced something very, very alarming for one very big project of 34,000 square feet where we have received black colored water with all solids. What went wrong? We don't know. It happened thrice in last 2.5 years. So, you know, water quality one has to understand in advance. And if the system is going to have some limitations, then either you provide for a number of, I would say, filters or have some kind of a system where it is monitored every day. Every time before irrigation, the quality of water should be actually monitored. And only if it is good to use, that can be used. Or otherwise, there are some systems which you don't need to irrigate through small drippers. You can irrigate them through larger nozzle, through by gravity. So this decision about irrigation is will happen only on the basis of water quality available. Even this water quality will change with the season. Summer will have more hard water, more salts in it, and probability is that in the rains it will be less. The project facing sea, near the sea, may have salt spray issue. There is a very narrow palette, plant palette available for salt spray sustaining plants. Media is something again, which is most crucial, very crucial. I can't say most crucial for every item. So it is also very crucial. Normally, if you ask 10 people, how do you make your soil lightweight? What do you use for vertical garden media? What do you use for green roof media to make it lighter? 9 of them will tell you cocoa peat, which is wrong answer. I have seen specifications where 30% cocopeat is written. Nobody knows what is going to happen after 1 year. 40% of this 30% cocopeat is going to deplete in 1 year. So you are going to have, you will have to replenish it. You have to add cocopeat again. And when you do something like, you know, green roof on 22nd floor or green wall on 12-storied building, how you are going to add this media? It is another installation. And, you know, there will be 4 to 6 to 10 cavities per square feet. How you are going to do this? So you, since you cannot do it easily, you avoid doing it. And then the final result is failure of the vegetation. So this is a problem I told. How do you handle this? You can normally have 15% biodegradable material. And say around rest of the material should be either non-biodegradable or very slow biodegradable. So on that basis, if we think about the overall 15% material will deplete in 4 to 5 years. So yearly you will have 5 to 10% maximum, which is allowable. When I say allowable, it is more, I'm telling this with experience, that the root zone of a plant also increases, its volume increases. So with that, and plant also gives back some humus. So with that, the formula is a depletion of 10% in the media every year, and there the root zone increases by almost similar quantity, so it gets balanced. So we think that for 5 years you don't need to replenish anything, and this is how the growth media should be prepared. Now in North India, if you use charcoal, if you use perlite, vermiculite, you don't have good brickbat. It is not porous, but some of the places may have a porous brickbat. So there you can use even brickbat. So all these things actually have a lot of aeration and they have thermal insulating properties. So you can always increase, this is all good for plants. So you can always try using this material and reduce root zone temperature. The humus and fine particles are also important because they provide a grip, they hold water, and they provide support, they hold even minerals, and they provide what plant wants. So they protect white roots. So with all these things together, one has to prepare right recipe for right zone. And if you have a liberty of planting separately, then probability is plant specific media. If all these things you are able to do, then your plants will never suffer. And this one has to learn by experience, by experimenting. There cannot be a ready formula on Google or in a book which can actually give you a solution for this. Even system-wise, the requirements change. There could be a system in which there is a water reservoir. We personally suggest that the irrigation should happen by capillary action. There should be a water reservoir at the bottom of the planter. When you irrigate, it should fill the water reservoir first and then it drains. After that, over the next, say, 35-40 minutes, by capillary action, water will come up. And this provides the right kind of moisture level inside the planter. And this is how, if you make right recipes, you are able to get benefit of very good growth and stable, I would say, root health. Irrigation is also important. Depending on the system, you can have different irrigation systems. For a very large project, for projects where access is a problem, and now post-COVID, I won't say post-COVID, under COVID conditions, now it is not so easy to monitor site. Yesterday when I saw in one of the new channel that Mumbai is going to have lockdown, not lockdown, Jamaabandi, Sancharbandi is what? Curfew for next 15 days. First thing that struck to my mind at 12 o'clock at night, that tomorrow I have only 24 hours now. Tomorrow I have to take care of all my large, big green walls which are exposed. I have to get them irrigated. So, you know, if the projects where we have automation, we are not worried. But still, our clients, they have not understood this importance of automation. Forget sensor-based automation. At least time-based automation is very much needed for all kind of gardening projects, not just green walls and green roofs. If you have a liberty to spend little more and have a sensor-based, then it is, additional advantage. We have to think out of the box. For irrigation system, normally, irrigation engineer would design sprinkler system for areas where a lot of water is required, more water is required. They will never provide you irrigation, sprinkler irrigation for shallow green roofs. But what is required, that one has to understand. Shallow green roofs are not going to store a lot of water. Those water reservoirs down, they are going to hold that water. When you irrigate this in the second slide, when you irrigate it above the soil, that is regular drip irrigation, the water quickly runs to the lower water reservoirs and drain. And the triangular portion in between that water flow, as you see, they actually get lesser water, and those areas may suffer. The first slide is showing subsoil irrigation, where water quickly travels all over, it covers. If you don't have a lot of temperature, that is, say below 33 degrees and above, if it is like that, then probability you will not be able to use this system, because there will be a competition between a rate of evaporation and a capillary action. So if there is a higher temperature and the speed of capillary is less, then plants will suffer. So one has to understand that it's not a formula given in the specification book of irrigation. One has to put his mind and understand that I have to take care of all the surface, plus I have to provide some storage, and that should be uniform. When this happens, your shallow green roof will hold sufficient water, moisture, and maybe you can consider there can be, instead of giving it for 5 minutes at a stretch, you can give it 2 minutes and have a 2 or 3 irrigation schedule of 2-3 times. So, you know, as I said, these are new things and new challenges. So one has to understand the performance of water, how it travels, complete hydrology, and how plant is going to get more. And even though it is low requirement, one may have to provide a sprinkler and not drip irrigation for this kind of situations. Access. If I cannot reach to the top, this green wall is going to die. That you have to keep in your mind right from first day. You will have to wait for installation till you are provided with a right cherry picker, hydraulic platform, scissor lift, whatever, a cradle. Without that, if you start, then you are going to suffer. One of our client having 70 feet tall green wall couldn't import cherry picker in time. After the inauguration, many times this happens, they decided not to spend money on cherry picker. This has happened for two big projects, not just one. After the handover, they decided not to buy but to hire. Now, whenever we want to have a schedule, either event or availability at the vendor's end is a problem. And we suffered a lot in first year. Only after we did a lot of buzz, then now we are getting it for 50% of the time than what we require. But see, you are helpless. You will see plants dying, but you cannot reach there. We wanted to change such damaged drip lines, but it took 4 months for us to get those lines, to get the access. So access is a necessity of a vertical garden. And if there is a problem, then one should not do green walls above the limit where you cannot access. I'm going to show one more image later on. It must be somewhere in the presentation, where a small narrow strip is provided. And for that, the cherry picker is required much longer time if you consider that in proportion with the surface area. I'll show that later. Yeah, 15 minutes. So this is, training is most important. There was a possibility of having hands-on training till before COVID. Now, online training and all these things, what INA has started, even some other ISOLA people, they have started having all this training. I believe now it should be focused more on a particular topic than, everything, telling everything. I also didn't want to focus on all the points this time, but I'm sure in a proper kind of a series of talks, one will be able to explain different things, which we are trying to cover in next, in 60 minutes. If we really want to talk about growth media, then understanding how many types of growth medias are possible, are available, and what are the benefits and what are the limitations. So then we need very good nurseries where they are soilless and they can be used readily in green walls. There should be a quantity, 40,000, 50,000 plants of same quality should be available at a very good price, better price. So this is also a challenge. Now, there are a few nurseries. Some are in Trivandrum, some are in Bangalore, some are in Pune, Mumbai. Then as you go up, as the temperature increases, there is a limitation on the plants which are suitable for indoor areas. So, increasing capability, increasing polyosis, if required, right kind of ventilation, fogging systems, all those are required for indoor plants and for outdoor green walls, green roofs. One should use only sustainable. You cannot use something which is not sustainable. Then comes, when somebody invests so much money on this kind of installation, warranties are necessary. There should be warranty against module, its breakage, its material quality, then probability UV, if required, fire resistant grade. All these things are very important, and there should be warranty, a certificate kind of thing, which we don't have. There are hardly few vendors who are able to tell that what is being used in this module. I have seen people doing plastic modules with 35 kg per 35 rupees per kg worth raw material. What it is going to give you? But nobody is asking certificate. Nobody checking what is happening. So that is why our green walls, we normally see potless, only grid we see. Against fabrication members, some people are using, I know Prasannamurthy is going to talk about standardization. So whatever he says is applicable to even this. So fabrication members, media, I have seen people using soil, manure, putting them in the pot, nobody thinks about that the locks which are provided to hold pot in place is produced to take a particular load, a lightweight load. But people put anything and those locks break, plants come down. There should be plant mortality warranty. Unfortunately, there is a tendency to earn by replacing plants, which is not good. If you are a bona fide installer, then you should give warranty of plant mortality. There is a possibility that somebody from client side wants something different, which is not sustainable. You can always mention in that this much percentage or mortality of one particular this species we will not support. There can be, they might want a seasonal plants. So you have to, barring that, you can always give plant mortality and prove your genuineness than giving red dye 25 rupees per change. Per plant mortality, we will charge you 60 rupees, 40 rupees, whatever. Joineries and hardware should be good joineries. People, the companies who provide hardwares, they provide you certificates. You go to Hilti, you go to Fishers, they provide you the quality. They also perform the test to check the strength of your wall, your structure. And on that basis, they suggest you. There could be a concrete in the wall. There could be hollow blocks. There can be ACP blocks. Each of these blocks require a different kind of fasteners. And companies like Hilti and others, they provide you that service free of cost. So you have to understand the structure, whether it is going to take load or not. If it is going to take load, then only you can put something. Otherwise, you have to have a independent green wall, independent of the structure. So this is important. Irrigation materials used. All the material cannot be, warranty cannot support all the materials, because if you have bad water, then tippers will definitely clog. But there are some parts which can be come under warranties. So I believe warranty is something very important for every genuine contractor. And for our industry, we really have to do this. There are people who come like a paint, they paint it and they go. This cannot happen. This is not going to give a boom to our industry. Right now, there are so many big architects who are not ready to use green walls because of the experiences they have. And we can't allow this to happen. We really need to have a right kind of support to our clients. The export opportunities, working abroad, and international associations. Even in this, people will trust you only if you respect intellectual properties. Otherwise, nobody will call you in foreign countries. Anyway, India and China, both the countries are already seen from a kind of suspicion. We have 5 international associations for representing them. But all of them were so suspicious initially that they always think that he is going to copy my product. So, creating a kind of confidence with this kind of companies, there you really have to be really reliable. Saying that I am reliable is not enough. Your product line, your everything that you are dealing in should prove that you are not disrespecting intellectual properties. Best quality materials to suit the standards of the buyer country. Now we are doing, we have done a big project in Dubai, and still we are doing some more. The kind of regulations, certifications, compliances they require. Now they are, even in India for few big projects, this is happening. But this, everything you have to prove. And unless you are used to provide quality material, quality services, you will never provide, you will never be able to provide for one project good service, good product, and for other project, bad service, bad product. This cannot happen. So you should be habitual to provide best material, best service. So even if when you are unaware, still you must have supplied a right material. You should be sure in your own mind. Here there were quite some issues, you know, the screws that we had not sent, and they, our associate in Dubai, they bought a local screws. Luckily, a lot of the installation that had happened was for less area. They made them remove those screws, and then the Hilti higher pitch screws were used. So, you know, one has to be sure about the methodology, materials and everything. People should have perfect knowledge and skills. My fabricator telling the PMC, project management consultant, that no problem, you put a tank on this floor. You know, he has no knowledge about that. But he told the PMC guy that you put that on seventh floor. Our green wall starts from sixth floor. That pressure should be suffice. Then I had to tell him that, no, we need 16 meter head. And this is not going to suffice. Why you answered his question, which you don't know? So, you know, even in your own company, your own staff, you have to educate them that they shouldn't open their mouth when they are not sure what they're talking about. In improving knowledge and skills is important, but at the same time, we have to create a culture in which right question is answered by right person. So perfection of knowledge and skills is important, and all over, right from top to bottom in your company, in your establishment. Timely delivery should always be planned. Nobody respects delay. In foreign countries, you in Europe and US, Canada, even Australia, all these places, you delay the delivery, you will have to pay for that. So we should take up schedules which are possible. Agreements, certification and compliances are important, and warranties. So all these things are very important if you want to start any venture in foreign countries. We are actually associated with Dubai. Thailand, we may start. They had come and they are trained. This is a team of Nongnuch Gardens, one of the biggest gardens. Malaysia. We worked in Maldives. We hired local teams from client, and this is the Maldives. This is a country, Kampala. This is in Uganda. So, you know, for Maldives and Uganda, we had sent plants from India. So packing, if you can look at these boxes and all that, you will understand how systematically it needs to be sent. So after 4 days of travel, it reached there. And out of that, 4 hours, our consignment in the afternoon was kept in open in the afternoon, 3 to 7 or something like that, at Abu Dhabi. So understanding that, we had taken all the care, and it reached there. And this is how we were there. In 4 days, we installed all this. This is in Bahrain. I believe this is the first project we did outside India with grass planted in vertical garden. So this is a lawn on the ground and lawn on the wall. I will not spend time on biophilic spaces because I had given a huge lecture on this, and maybe on the blog or somewhere you can see this. You can take down this Terrapin Bright Green Living Architectural Academy. You can refer and you can just go through this. Basically, in short, it is impact of Akash, Vayu, Agni, Jala, Prithvi on our five senses. And it is an equilibrium of all these Panchamahabhuta, that is five elements, on our five senses, and how we feel them, whether we are happy, whether we are unhappy. That that expertise is about this. It improves your health, productivity, healing, and all these things. So basically, it means thick foliage, colorful flowers, scent, clear water, water bodies, sound of water, filtered light, swaying vegetation and breezes, safe and sheltered places, secure feeling, natural materials, pleasing shapes resembling natural forms. So these are the basic features of biophilic spaces. So Prasannamurthy, 5 minutes.
Yes sir, please go ahead.
Okay,
fine, I'm ready.
Yeah, thank you. So roop, dvani, sparsha, gandha, rasa, all these things are available in this. So when we say something is biophilic, so this is basically, it gives you a feeling of liveliness. This is a small shaft along this leaf lobby. So it has made such a narrow shaft green and lively. This is outdoor conference room, and actually client wants to come and sit here only instead of sitting inside. Swimming pool with a privacy shade. Privacy again from the building, from using pergola and green roof. So these are the opportunities. There are opportunities available in green wall industry, green walls on the rent, that also you will see quickly. Specialization in indoor gardening. One has to study light intensity and plants, how they respond, what light intensity is required for which plant, for how many hours. So if you are able to observe this and come out with that expertise, there is enormous scope for in the future. Then urban farming is there, maintenance services, irrigation automation, retail, media manufacturing, and manure manufacturing. See, this is a balcony, open terrace rather, and it got converted into such a fabulous space by just assembling modules. Nothing is constructed, everything is retrofit. This is Nexco rental. This is a Tata company stall, Tata Motor stall in Expo. And my associate worked for this. I believe the charges he was paid was 26 lakhs rupees. And he must have covered some costs, all the costs, plus maybe 50% of the materials. Then he did this. This is again 18-19 lakhs rupees for one night. So, this kind of opportunities are coming. If you are ready to take the challenge, you have a chance. Why do they fail? Module design, growth media, wrong growth media, support system problem, wrong structure, joinery, irrigation and water management failing, plant selection, access as and when required, failure to maintenance expertise, and this is the last is also very important, failure due to incorrect specifications. Anyway, don't look at the stamp where it is. I shouldn't have kept it open, but something went wrong. So, this is a smart city project with vertical garden, see the list for outdoor well developed plants. Peperomia outdoor, Syngonium outdoor, Philodendron outdoor. This is a tender and these are the specifications given in such a tender. What do you expect from vendor also? So this is the situation of our industry. And Chlorophytum, Lantana pilea, Royo, that is fine. Lantana is fine. But look at the upper A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, Z. Some more are there. Croton, Mahatma Dracaena, Irisin. So, you know, this is what, where we are. We have so much, you know, way to go. These 20 techniques I'm not going to tell today. Someday later. I believe now I have to give it over to President Murthy. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Barmande sir, for giving very informative presentation. What I, in short, I will say, you given a wide journey of vertical garden from start to end. You have covered almost all the points related to vertical gardening and farming. So I really thankful on behalf of Indian Nursery Association for giving us such a informative presentation. You have touched all the aspects of the vertical gardening, like small things. Just I will point out your wind velocities and major factor. You have mentioned the automation, importance of automation. Now in the lockdown, we are everybody is realizing the importance of we'll get the importance of automation. So I'm really thankful to you for giving such a wonderful presentation on vertical gardening. Thank you very much, Barmande sir, once again. Now we are with another speaker, Prasanna Murthy Desai sir. Sir, always a chetna for all of us. सर जब बात करते हैं तो एक चेतना आती है, एक मोटिवेशन आता है, वो कहाँ से है, तो उनके बोलने से इतने चेतना आती है. मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि जब देसाई साहब बात करते हैं तो जो भी पार्टिसिपेंट्स उनका इतना मोटिवेशन और इंस्पिरेशन मिलता है कि उसी हिसाब से उनको लगता है कि वी शुड अचीव दैट क्वालिटी एंड ऑल द पैरामीटर्स. सर का अभी 24 साल का तजुर्बा है इन द फील्ड ऑफ दिस हॉर्टिकल्चर एंड लैंडस्केपिंग. सर is a long-standing member of the Chartered Institute of Horticulture, American Society of Landscape Architects, and has taken a lead in many environmental initiatives of Tata Trust and BMC Mumbai. He also worked with Tree Authority of Mumbai and BNHS advisory panels for conservation of flora and fauna of coastal Mumbai. Prasanna Murthy Desai sir is currently heading the Bangalore International Airport's Landscape Department, spreading the landscape development theme around the terminal in the garden for the largest airport expansion infrastructure development of the country. Sir, आपका तजुर्बा, आपका experience यहाँ पे हम सब participants को बहुत महत्वपूर्ण होने वाला है, तो everybody, all the participants are actually anxious to hear you. So ज्यादा समय ना लेते हुए आई विल रिक्वेस्ट प्रसन्न मूर्ति देसाई सर टू स्टार्ट हिज प्रेजेंटेशन. सो ओवर टू यू प्रसन्न मूर्ति सर.
गुड आफ्टरनून गाइस, आई जस्ट पुट माय प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन द स्क्रीन. Good afternoon, everybody. Once again, thank you INA for conducting such a knowledge sharing session to all the budding people and the people who are in this industry since long. My presentation will be a little broader. Most probably I would like to touch every part of landscape as such, apart from the opportunity called as green wall and vertical. I think, remember this number, this is a number which keeps us thrilling because this is endless opportunity, which is more than 4 lakh number of plants. You know, individual plant can be a big business altogether. Secondly, what we look at it from a large perspective is we are a nation in terms of large manpower, which can be trained properly, which can be put up in such a context that we participate we make sure that we turn the situation in next 5 to 10 years in terms of making this as a countable country in terms of standards, in terms of intellectual property rights, what Pradeep said. Yes, it's a big problem with all of us. International community don't trust us easily, whether any nurseryman or whether it is a buyer, whether it is a user experience as well. Why I have put this slide is just you need to understand. We have 150 crore people who require this, you know, at one point of time. So they are all potential customers, because I remember the people who are in this presentation is mostly the students and the businessmen and the people who are intended to become a businessman. How to look at perspective? For me, if I'm a businessman, I look at a population of 710 crores worldwide. For me, mujhe dhanda karna hai. I want to do the business. Har aadmi mera potential customer hai. Not only every Indian, every person is a potential customer for me. When it comes to the vertical walls, I just would like to talk in terms of from an angle of user. User perspective, when we look at vertical gardening or a green wall or a green roof, we look at all these aspects. I just don't want to look at, I don't want to explain everything because my slides are too many. I want to cover a lot of areas. Basically, when somebody is actually either designing or executing or planning to do a business, just understand what you are getting into in terms of aesthetics, whether it is in terms of only marketing or you just want to do it for yourself in your house. In terms of anything, whether it is green wall, green roof, your vertical walls, urban farming, landscape, everything holds good for all these terms. These are basically the questions which you are asking when you start to plan for anything. Before we hit into the business standards, standards of India, standards of the world, and standards expectation from the customer perspective. Where are you planning this? Whatever the thing, where are you planning? Because the whole success or the whole business perspective depend on where you're planning. Space, how much standards, if you look at the very close by the standards, when I refer, because the written standards are basically either US or BS code, that is British system, or an hybrid of both, that is a Singapore system. You know, when we really talk about whether it is a structural system, whether it is a system which is whether it is for plant media, plant size, plant specifications in terms of what material to use, where to use, all defined by these three grand specification list, standardization list. When we come to green wall or green roofs, one thing you need to consider is you need to advise whether if it is a freestanding, then it's fine. If it is not freestanding, if it is abutting the surrounding walls, you need to think, you need to advise in terms of waterproofing. Waterproofing as a business is also a big theme, along with your landscape idea. You need to look at that also. What plays very critical is in terms of light. When you look at these plants are living, they require sunlight or an artificial augmented light for the survival of this entire system. Ease of working is one more thing. Make or break of the entire green wall depends on ease of working. Wind, he already explained. Plant selection, I'll get into it as a business module. Whether it is in, whether you're catering to 150 crores of Indian population or you're looking at a 7.1 billion population of the world, you need to understand, what you are getting into. What every place, every country holds a different, consideration for import. It's a very potential industry. Maybe if we start today, maybe in 5 years, we will be in a countable number. In terms of, export, I think there are only 2-3 agencies who does this job out of India. Even though we are a large country in terms of all these things, but we are not there yet. What you need to look at is as a end user, the most critical part, if you really ask me, everything can provided you have a proper strong growth media. I'll also explain that separately. irrigation is very critical because without water nothing can survive. Only the non-living stuff can do well on the vertical walls. You also need to look at combining irrigation and fertilizer together so that the ease of working enhances. One more critical aspect is you must know what plant, what is their pest and disease, because these are all augmented areas. You know, the growth media and the pockets are less than 4 inches to 6 inches, and at times it is maybe a 300 to 400 mm kind of a growth media. So these are all vulnerable. All the plants are little vulnerable when it comes to indoor or maybe outdoor where it is not taken care of. They are exposed to most sucking pests and all other insects, which you need to know. Whether you are a nurseryman, whether you are an end user, you must know what you are getting into and what is it. How do you control those pests and diseases? It's a large subject to address. Yes, one critical area is also trained manpower. Whether you are a nurseryman or whether you are an executor, you must train your local resources, or you need to work in an association wherein there are people who are specialized for execution, there are people who are specialized for production, there are people who are going to only assemble that. You also need to look at maintenance. I'll talk regarding maintenance in a little long way because I'm an end user. So you must know what maintenance is all about. Machinery, yes. If you're crossing more than 3 meters, you must need machinery. Below 3 meters is all just do it yourself. Fire hazard, yes. When you are looking at an export agency, yes, fire hazard is a big thing. Pradeep has covered a lot of things about soil media. Yes. It is the must thing what you need to watch for. Non-degradable material. I'm talking in terms of a very large perspective here. I'm looking at you guys as a future exporters from India. I would love to read your names in next 5 years, that few of you are actually exporting the thing from India, considering all the standard requirement, each and every standardized either Europe or America or Australia or Asian continent requirement, you are adhering to it. You are adhering to the intellectual property rights. What you need to look when you look at a soil media is in terms of how light it is, how rich in terms of nutrients. Mostly they are all inert, so you need to augment artificially in terms of nutrients. You also should look at material which is very good in terms of aeration, good in terms of drainage. It needs to be pest-free, especially the fungus and nematodes, you know, because they are born out of the soil media. The tried and tested ones since last 24, 25 years, this industry is not a maybe new industry for India, but when you look at all these standard people who are working in either US or in Europe, there it's nearly 30, 35, 40 years, 1960 means around 40, 45 years old industry. Standardization came into picture in 1980s by AS, American Standard of American Standards. Later on, people followed that. They improvised based on their individual country, whether it is plant growth, whether it is plant media, whether it is in terms of systems, whether you are doing it as a felt system, whether doing it as a pot or a hybrid of both, or you are looking at a capillary action material, which is very popular in Netherlands and most part of France. All these felt material which came from them. In India, the most tested and the best is these pot or a living wall, which has proper clear space for growth. What you are growing, what you want to keep it for how many years, life cycle of that entire wall, all needs to be captured either while designing or selling, or actually when you are putting it across to anybody who is buying it. Customers may not be knowing the integrities of these vertical walls. You need to be honest. You need to own what you are selling. The most critical standard, why standards are made, is all about owning what you are selling. Aapne bech diya, kaam tamam ho gaya, ye attitude nahi chalega. If you really want to succeed in this industry, the ownership of the plant, the ownership of the product, 100% belongs to the producer. Yes, after selling, after taking the money, your role ends to an extent. But you need to give a complete knowledge what you are selling it to them. बेच दिया भूल गया आपका धंधा भी बंद हो जाएगा. इट इज अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग स्टेटमेंट व्हाट आई एम मेकिंग बिकॉज यू कैन डू दिस बिजनेस फॉर वन डे टू डे और 10 days और 1 year और 5 years बट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डू इट फॉर जनरेशन 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 टू जनरेशन इफ यू रियली वॉन्ट टू डू इट फॉर एज अ लेगेसी यू नो I'll show you a video of a person who is his nursery, who established the nursery 35 years back to sell plant. Now, can you imagine? It's an idea. It's very weird, but now he is making billions, not even in millions, in billions of dollars, because it is a kind of effort what they have put in. It is the trust what they have put in, trust to sell, trust to their business, trust in terms of between customers and you. These are all things which needs to be known, because I feel I'm talking to all the industry people, the people who want to convert nursery ka jo maligiri into an area which is called as an industry. See, as such, in India, the precariousness is all the people, including me, you, people who are selling or the people who are designing it are more or less in terms of malis only. We are not a businessman, because we lack in terms of attitude, we lack in terms of chalta hai thing. We really are not serious. Whether I can name all the nurseries in India. Most of you guys know me. Whoever is selling, whatever the things are, we will look at individual areas. You might see there is a difference between why Europe, why America is so different, why Singapore can produce so many great landscape features. What Pradeep has showcased, because they don't do anything. They don't accept anything mediocre. They don't accept anything which they don't even show what is mediocre. If you look at the things what we regularly see, we all accept as it is. We need to stop this. If you really are looking at creating this entire thing as an industry, what else? Yes, we need to look. When you are working in, especially in indoor, I think light plays a major role. If you are selling it to people who are actually utilizing this for their indoors, please put up a. You need to study this. I have attached nearly 100 study materials, around 20 books to this presentation, in terms of standards, in terms of how the work happens worldwide, how the things are taken care of. What do you really mean by lighting? Lighting is not in terms of general lighting. Lighting in terms of lux level, matching to the frequency or a wavelength of color band. What is there in the sunlight? What violet. What means red, what means yellow. These are all the things which you need to understand while you are putting up a artificial light. Everything depends in terms of lighting. The standard specification starts with 3 meter and above. If you are below 3 meter, the specifications are very different. The fixtures are very different. If it is more than 3 meters, if you are looking at a height of around say 12 meter, 10 meter or 15 meter or 50 meter as an open space, the specifications do differ. You just need to understand the wavelength and the lux level reaching to the height of where you are placing the plant material. The whole success of this entire green wall or a vertical wall depends on the quality of light what it gets. See, aspirationally, every client wants rose, carnation. Even somebody wants kamal to flower in his green wall. That is an aspirational level, but you need to be sure that what is going to flower, that only is recommended. What is the kind and quality of light? Until unless as a sales, it will be a big problem. Right now, what landscape architects all crib about is it fails because. Nobody has ever considered all these factors in a holistical way. When you sell, when you design, when you plan, please look at this, because the whole success, whether it is urban farming, whether it is aesthetical greenery, whether it is your green roof, everything depends on the quality of light also. A lot of variations. It all started with a few are just to showcase in terms of world's best stuff. Light I already covered. In terms of what else in terms of plant options, as an horticulturist, I would be more interested to know, put some light on all these things. When you actually propagate or when you actually do the things, or when you are putting up the things in the right perspective, There is a clear cut definition. There are clear cut standards into plant palette, material, structural details. On the livewall.com, it's an American company. They have given their whole standards in terms of whether it is structure, whether it is waterproofing, whether it is the size of the pot, where is the pot placed, whether indoor, outdoor, what is the height of the area when you are doing it, what kind of plant material is suitable for the size of the plant, size of the pot, you know, it's 4 inch, 6 inches, felt, or grow media induced, the you know, you have something which is called as a, you know, all these medias which don't require watering for next, you know, at least 2 months or 3 months. If you saturate it by 100% moisture, you really don't need to do it when you're doing it on a floor, which is on the ceilings, which are nearly 10 to 12 meter high, which we are planning to do in the airport right now. Individual plant wise, whether it is annual, perennial, or whether it is edible, you are doing it for an edible green wall, whether you're doing it with succulents, whether you're doing it with tropicals, indoor, outdoor, all the standards, all the specifications are quite different. These are the general plants which we can very easily grow here in India in terms of if somebody wants to start a business which is only to sell the plant, which is only to sell the plants in terms of international standards, only one thing you need to take care is no soil is allowed in any countries, whether you want to export out of India, whether you want to import in India, it always has to be an inert media. Wherein the microbes and the pests are not you know, circulated between two countries. In terms of success, it basically starts with maintenance. I don't want to call this as a maintenance. I would like to call it as a an industry's success. Success depends on how meticulously you are planned in terms of your maintenance. Whether it is your one single wall, whether it is a wall which is kilometer long, whether it is which place, whether it is on facade, whether indoor, outdoor, in, you know, on your balcony or on your ceiling or on your facade, everything needs to be planned proper before even you know, you start this business. Someone who's buying it, you need to ask these relevant questions. Bechna sirf bechne ke wajah se mat karo. Bechna is in terms of building a relationship which lasts forever. You know, people put the trust on you. People are buying there because they are coming to you as an expert who's actually propagating and who's actually selling that. The ownership lies with you. The trust factor lies with you. So be careful. Whoever is buying, you need to advise him that this is what it requires as a maintenance. You need to put people across based on the, if he is an individual, you need to ensure that it's a less frequently maintained system, what you need to propagate and sell it to the people. You need to tell people in terms of do's and don'ts. I just don't want to go into everything because there are a lot of things which I want to talk today. You just need to tell people in terms of how system is going to fail. Failure is not due to the model, or failure is not due to that individual system. Failure is due to basically the operations, what do they carry. Whether in terms of taking care of plants, whether in terms of irrigation, whether in terms of putting up the, you know, choked walls, whether it is a system which is not affixed properly, it is tilting, the irrigation drop is actually fall on some place and it is not happening because it is not, you know, placed properly. These things need to be told. When you sell a component in such a way that you give them a complete do's and don'ts, whoever is blowing, you know, buying it. Basic issue with irrigation system is a root blockage. The drainage is blocked. The failure is one major reason because the, you know, roots have a tendency to grow. If some root escapes out of a growth media, gets into the nozzle, it will choke the irrigation system and plants tend to die. So you need to be make sure that what you are getting into and what are the chances of failure. And the last aspect, when it comes to the large master plans or large areas where you are doing this green wall or you are advising this green wall, is in terms of usage of you know, machinery. If it is more than 3 meters without machineries, you do whatever, it's going to fail. So anything more than 3 meters, please advise them to have proper machineries, whether it is your hydra, whether it is your cherry picker, whether it is your, you know, all these machineries which are part of the maintenance scheme. In terms of, as a business, if somebody is looking at it, what product you want to sell. You need to emphasize on that. You need to be very crisp, clean, and tell people why are you selling and what are you selling. Apart from that, you need to price it properly. प्राइसिंग मेरे बाजू वाला नर्सरी वाला 400 रुपए में बेच रहा है, मैं अगर 350 में बेचूंगा एक बार बेच पाओगे, बार बार नहीं बेच पाओगे. अंडरस्टैंड, आपको प्राइस इस तरह से बेचना है. अगर वो 2500 भी आप मांगोगे ना, उसका रिलेवेंस बताओ. यू टेल पीपल वाई आर यू सेलिंग इट एट 2500 रुपीज. गिव हिम द गारंटी, गिव हिम द वारंटी, गिव हिम द अश्योरेंस दैट यू स्टैंड बाय योर प्रोडक्ट. इट इज ऑल अबाउट अश्योरिंग योर सेल्फ. प्राइस in any international market or any every country, the pricing differs. Or pricing differs in terms of the quality standards fixed for the plants, quality standards fixed for the product which is not plant. Anything which is not plant, which can be your growth media, which can be your chemicals, which can be your augmented things like light, relative humidity. Everything depends on thing apart from the labor charges. What advantage as we all Indians have? We have 150 crore capable, human population. What they require? They require the training. They require the technical know-how. They need to know what they are getting into. Basically, for marketing, there are 4 P's for a successful marketing. One is product. Second is price. Third, how do you promote yourself? The promotional aspects, I'll tell you what all you can promote and how all you can promote yourself in terms of not only your actual quality of your product, also in terms of human psyche attached, wellness attached, medicinal properties attached, edible, non-edible, flowering, non-flowering, flavor, fragrance, endless opportunity in terms of promotional capacity. Coming to a place, yes, you need to tell them which place, what is suitable when you're selling. So if you are thorough with all these 4 P's, your business model is going to succeed. It is not my ideas or not my principles here. These are all derived by Howard. There are large books to read on all these traits. What else apart from green walls and vertical walls? These are also green walls and vertical walls. And you know, this is a new trend which is happening. Do some research. I have attached some links to know more about all these stuff. It's altogether a different world, altogether a different drama, altogether a different context to sell, to context to make as a business idea. As in terms of Indian industry, yes, these data are at least 3 years old. We are doing something, but it is not to the extent what US or what European countries are doing. What we are looking at, you need to understand where do you market yourself without much of an expense on in terms of marketing. Take the help of social media. Pandemic in terms has helped us all of us to go back to our mobiles. We are all busy with the things. We check our Facebook, we check our Twitter, we check our all social medias. Utilize that. It's a great platform to sell your product. Without even putting up your shop, without you putting up your anything, you have the facility. Make sure that you make a nice product catalog. Be crisp, be specific in terms of what you're selling. Make sure that aim at making a branding, not as a business. The brand survives, brand sustains, brand goes for hundreds of years. You know, one great brand is Tata's, just to give it. It's a brand, it's nothing else. The brand which built the trust can last forever is a great example as Tata. Look at what international pricing and what international base benchmark rates what are available. I don't want to compete with Pradeep. I don't want to compete with people who are all there in India. I want you guys to excel more than that. Give a competition to Pradeep. Look at countries which are just 2 hours, 1 hour, 2.5 hours away from India. You know, that is as good as like traveling from Bangalore to Delhi takes more time from traveling from Delhi to Dubai. You know, a big business opportunity. Where is the business coming from? Business is coming from Middle East, business is in US, business is in Europe, business is in Asian countries, the developing Asian countries like Singapore, Hong Kong. Lot of things are happening in Philippines. Don't underestimate the potential of Philippines, Cambodia, Laos. Huge projects are coming, which are thousands and thousands of acres. Millions and millions of dollars are put in just to bring in the bio, greenery driven landscape. The cities are happening in the, US is building nearly 120 different cities in, they expand around the oceans. Dubai is already set an example. There is a huge 3,600 kilometer development in Red Sea. The whole Red Sea is getting converted into a future destination like Dubai. It is not distant. Works are happening. Master plan is happening. Who's supplying all these materials? I mean, maybe barring two, three companies in India, who supplies? Where the material is coming from? Material is coming from countries which are just unimaginable, like Thailand. I mean, can you imagine Thailand 10 years back was nothing. They were just like us. In 10 years, the RAPO what they built is humongous. Malaysia, one of the biggest exporters of greenery. We are not exporting anything. Major things which are coming from is basically the old countries like Europe, Spain, Italy, France, Holland, and your Belgium. Belgium is what? Delhi se bhi chota country hai. Shayad humse hamara jitna GDP hai usse jyada log export kar rahe hai, that kind of potential this industry has. Understand that. I don't want to go into these figures. Everything is defined. Green roofs, green walls. Look at the perspective. Why I given these numbers is per square meter pe $200. Iska 10 takka. India mein kahan se milne wala itna paisa tum logo ko? Khud ko bechoge to itna nahi milne wala. $200 ka 10 takka bhi aapko mila. What great profits you are going to earn. Ye, I'm not telling just as it is. Even if you spend average $800 to $1,000 is what they spend. 10% is $100. India mein 100 customer nahi, 10,000 customer ko aap jo ek bar bechoge, world mein ek customer ko bechoge. I mean, that is the kind of potential what I'm talking about. Green facades, every component, how do you price? You need to price in terms of what are the other intricate details involved in that. Jiske saath mein, it is in there, whether it is one, sub layer details, what is part of it. You also need to know what also needs to be done below your system to keep it successful. All these things derive in terms of pricing of your material. Why I am stressing so much? Bahut sasta labor hai. Labor ko train karo. Ever, this will not stop because we don't have anything to export. So Indian rupee is definitely going to fail because we are not even charged to take up the, intense to bring it down, bring it to the dollar level. No, I toh bolta hoon, ye business opportunity hai. Ek rupay, unka ek rupay aapko 70 rupay dega, ya 80 rupay dega. Shayad jate jate, aur 5 saal mein shayad ye 100 rupay mein bhi pohunch jayega. Your efforts, whether it is done in Europe, whether it is done on moon or on some other planet, effort remains same. The profit margins can be increased. The efforts can be made fruitful by sending it to places or people who can afford to buy your things at a better price. What else in terms of vertical green wall? Aap herbal cocktail garden bana sakte ho, aap moss wall bana sakte ho, fern gardens bana sakte ho, cacti bana sakte ho, therapeutic garden bana sakte ho, colorful living wall bana sakte ho. So many other things. I will not read all these stuff. I'll just show you some business ideas, some nice cacti walls. These are all ready to sell. Huh? These are all available on your Google. You can buy this readily. People can buy all these ideas provided you have a ready solution and ownership to stand by them when they are in trouble. You can charge them. The trend has already started. We are all suffered this. Main toh chahata tha ke koi mujhe edible green wall beche. Mere ghar ke liye mujhe chahiye tha 6 mahine se. Dar ke mare mein kahin market bhi nahi ja pa raha hu. Ghar pe demand to hai, khana pina to hum sabko hai. So ye business opportunity aap kyun nahi samajh pate ho? It needs to be popularized. Give them at a right price. Aap replacement ke hisab se do na. Aap agar 1 square meter green wall, agar edible green wall bech rahe ho, aap bolo ek system aap ek bar mein le lo. Mahine mein main aake aapko exchange karke deta hu itne paise mein. मार्केट से आप अगर एक कोथिंबीर 20 रुपए में लेते हो, आप अगर घर में प्रोड्यूस करते हो, नो केमिकल्स, नो हैजार्डस थिंग, आपके सामने ग्रो हो रहा है, आपका घर का ग्रो हो रहा है, गिव सम नाइस टैंजिबल एंड आइडियाज विच एक्चुअली कैन वर्क. इट्स अ मैजिक, इट्स अ कंटेजियस, एंड इन टर्म्स ऑफ बिजनेस इट इज एन एक्सपोनेंशियल थिंग. अंडरस्टैंड दैट दे हैव एवरीथिंग, यू नो, दे कैन, यू कैन टेल देम, दे कैन ग्रो बेस्ड ऑन देयर ओन waste what they develop, you know, generate in their house. The waste can be converted into organic manure. The same manure can be part of my green wall system, and they can grow their vegetables. Some other ideas. I would like to show an idea where it is urban farming basically.
In our Real Food series this morning, we're taking a look at the growing trend of vertical farming. The world's population will climb around 7 billion people to nearly 10 billion by 2050. That will make it even more challenging to feed everybody on the planet. Companies like Arrow Farms are rethinking how we grow the vegetables by going up to provide fresh and affordable produce. Michelle Miller is at an Arrow Farms indoor growing facility in Newark, New Jersey, with the technology behind vertical farming. That's what it's called.
आपको बताऊं, मैं न्यू जर्सी, एक दिल्ली से भी छोटा सा शहर है.
Looks like arugula, kale, watercress, all growing indoors on shell stack 7.
I would like to showcase this a multi-billion dollar industry. It's a very popular industry which is going to rock. We already started, we already see many people participating. I expect you guys to put some thought on this, because it's a very, very potential industry for next 30 to 50 year industry. You can be innovative in terms of making a pot. इसमें कुछ भी नहीं है, सीधा साधा पॉट है, ये ग्रोथ मीडियम है, ऊपर लाइट लगाया, ग्रो लाइट. दे आर सेलिंग दिस एट अ प्राइस ऑफ 80,000 रुपीज टू 1 lakh ऑफ रुपीज पर पॉट. आप देसी बना सकते हो, जुगाड़ दुनिया भर का हो सकता है. यू नो, होल थिंग कैन बी मेड इंडियनाइज. यू जस्ट नीड टू पुट योर आइडियाज, यू जस्ट नीड टू मेक श्योर दैट you don't copy it, because it's again an international, you know, intellectual property, right? You can enhance this by adding it into a different perspectives here. Aap sirf indoor ke liye bhi soch sakte ho, as a green wall soch sakte ho, as other ideas you can populate this. You remember the name, it is Spouts IO. It's a AI based system, very simple, meticulous system. You can make it at a very, very cost effective thing. Look at these business ideas. Apart from that, what we can also grow these things in the containers. We can go and sell in front of these societies. See, at times what happens is, you know, post pandemic, how these countries are recovering is in Paris, just a month, 15 days back, they started an exercise by government that 15 minutes life is what they call it. So that in 15 minutes, whatever you require to leave is available. Most crucial part is eatables. You cannot live in hum sadhu log to hai nahi, pani aur air pe jee nahi sakte, so we require food. So food grown on the trucks, food grown, brought to their house in front of them, they can harvest and take it. Good, great ideas. What else? I hope you guys won't stop me. I will deviate from that main topic, because the opportunities to encourage people are quite limited. Sachin ji and people, I hope you guys would like to listen more.
Absolutely, absolutely. Please go ahead.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, basically what happened, you know, this is the system which I saw 5 years back when I went to Singapore to see one of the projects. I didn't believe, you know, maybe this is going to rock. You know, in next 5 to 10 years, the whole glass facade failed in India. Glass facade failed in many countries where the temperature soar more than 33 degrees. This is a new technology which came from Germany. It's developed by Alina Scheck. She's a biologist, a German biologist. She bought this technology. Basically, how it operates is very interesting. Maybe emotionally you don't look at it. You look at it from a business perspective. ये business है. यहाँ emotion के लिए जगह थोड़ी सी कम होती है. प्लांट को मैं उल्टा कैसे ग्रो करूंगा? प्लांट ग्रोज दिस वे हैप्पीली बिकॉज it made confused in terms of gravitational pull and the sun's direction. How it happens is this pot actually rotates by 180 degrees. So the confusion lies with the plant whether to grow vertically or horizontally or to remain as it is. So plants tend to remain as it is for at least 3 to 4 years. They don't lose their shape, they don't lose their size. Very efficiently operated system, again AI based, very simple technology. Everything is on the control based, whether it is irrigation, whether, and again the soilless media, whether irrigation, fertigation, pests and diseases are quite less because mostly it is played with ficus varieties. Understand, India is the GUD. It's a base for all ficus varieties of the world. India holds world's oldest forest, Gondwana, that is our Western Ghats. We have bought 56 varieties of ficuses to the cultivation mode. So 56 opportunities of export. No one has varieties. Who grows, who exports? Thailand. Cambodia is exporting ficuses. We are nowhere. I mean, it's irony. Like, why are we not thinking? Guys, I'm giving you some thoughts in terms of think differently. There are opportunities. पेंडेमिक पोस्ट पेंडेमिक प्री पेंडेमिक अगला 50 साल ये धंधा बंद नहीं होने वाला है. जब तक ह्यूमन रेस है तब तक नर्सरी की बिजनेस है. सिर्फ सोच बदलो, सब कुछ बदलेगा. देश नहीं, हम नहीं, सब कुछ बदल सकता है. आपकी शहर, आपकी छोटी सी गांव, आपकी छोटी सी गलियारों से लेके देश और पूरा कॉन्टेक्स्ट बदल सकता है. आई विल शो यू हाउ इट हैज हैपेंड इन टर्म्स ऑफ नाउ. आई वुड लाइक टू टॉक दी स्टैंडर्ड्स. आई हैव अटैच्ड एवरीथिंग. I request everyone to go through carefully, understand why standards are made and what the implications of that. 710 crore population, har ek ke liye map, what we measure remains same when we have standards. If you write on your tree or on your pot, it is ANSI Z60.1 standard. America will not even question where it has come from. Whether it is from Bangladesh or from Timbuktu, no one questions because you are adhering to the standards what is being defined in that letter. What it stands for? It stands for the measurement in terms of height, girth and caliper of the plant. It stands in terms of what size you are looking at, whether it's a root level, whether it has a crown level, whether it is a spread of the whole stuff. Determining proper relationship between the height and the caliper, it is defined a इतना डेटा तो हम और 50 साल में नहीं बना पाएंगे बिकॉज हमको नहीं बनाने का. वी डोंट वांट इट टू कन्वर्ट दैट इनटू एन इंडस्ट्री. अगर हमको अगर इंडस्ट्रियल प्रोपोर्शन में ये सब कुछ करने का था तो शायद हम लोग सबसे पहला झाड़ बेचने से पहले हम लोग स्टैंडर्ड बेचते हैं. हम लोग ये स्टैंडर्ड के माल बेचते हैं. सो बी केयरफुल इवन आई एंटरिंग इन टू माई प्रीमाइसेस बिकॉज आई एम स्टैंडर्ड. सो माई थिंग्स आर ऑलवेज स्टैंडर्ड अलॉन्ग विथ माई प्राइसिंग. तो कोई कभी पूछेगा ही नहीं तुम लोगों को क्यों इतना कॉस्टली हो या क्यों इतना कम हो. एवरी थिंग इज डिफाइंड टू द स्टैंडर्ड फॉर 710 करोड़ पॉपुलेशन. वॉट एल्स? डिटरमाइनिंग वेदर द रूट वॉल और द कंटेनर. दिस इज बियॉन्ड योर ग्रीन वॉल एंड ग्रीन यू नो वर्टिकल वॉल. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट अ बिग इंडस्ट्री कॉल्ड एज इन सनराइज इंडस्ट्री. आई विल कॉल इट एज green is tree, full grown tree. A big painful area for me since last 25 years. Agar yahi dhang se karta raha to shayad meri zindagi bhar ye problem rehne wala hi hai. We are sorting out, we are making in house, but these efforts are very small in terms of the Indian growth what we are looking at. Pandemic aaj nahi, aaj ke ek saal ke baad isko koi dawa aa jayegi, dhanda chalta rahega. Look at a perspective, the whole government's vision for next 15-20 years is only infrastructure and infrastructure. Ghar, aapka dukaan ya business aspects or the real estate, they will all keep growing depending on the growth of the human population. Shahar mein 70% population rahegi aur 5-10 saal mein. Gaon mein koi rehne wala nahi, kisi ko gaon mein nahi rehna hai. Gaon mein jo rahega wo crorepati ban sakta hai provided मैं जो बोल रहा हूँ उसका 10% कोई कर पाए. Somebody get influenced and start doing this on a regular note. What else it influences? It brings the buyers on a single platform. It brings the systems on single platform. It talks about only one language when we are actually looking at it as a business perspective. What it covers is a general standard. It covers to individual specific plants, whether it is shade, deciduous, conifer, whether it is broadleaf one, whether it is for roses, whether it is for shrubs, young plants, fruit trees, small trees, you know, I just quickly run through how those standards are defined in terms of figures. I always believe pictures and figures is always easy to memorize than going into the details. Trees basically measure for a depth of the root ball, width of the root ball, and the height of the plant, and the you know, in terms of number of branches which is defined, average spread at the canopy level, what is the root diameter. In terms of shrubs, see, aap green wall ki plant baat karte ho, wo bahut sare to shrub bhi hote hain ya ground covers hote hain, they are generalized as shrubs. The standard here is kitne branching hai, 2 hai, 3 hai, 4 hai, at what level, niche root level pe itna upar hai या उसके ऊपर है या सिर्फ चार डंडी और आप 8 इंच के जो कचरे की थैली में डाल के जो बेचते हो वो नहीं चलने वाला इंटरनेशनल स्टैंडर्ड में. दीज स्टैंडर्ड्स आर डिफाइंड. प्लीज मेक श्योर दैट 10 ऑफ यू स्टार्ट दिस. बिलीव मी, इन नेक्स्ट 5 इयर्स द एंटायर कंट्री इज गोइंग टू फॉलो दिस. इन टर्म्स ऑफ हाइट मेजरमेंट ऑफ एवरग्रीन ट्रीज इज वेरी डेफिनेटली डिफाइंड. इन टर्म्स ऑफ वॉट हाइट, वॉट एवरेज स्प्रेड ऑफ द ट्री, वेर इज द टिपिकल ब्रांचिंग, हाउ टू मेजर, वॉट टू मेजर. मैंने मेरे बीओक्यू में, हर बीओक्यू मेरी जो एयरपोर्ट से जो बीओक्यू आती है, हर जगह में मैं डाल के देता हूँ. मैं मेरी एक एक्सपीरियंस आपको दिखाऊंगा, इंडिया का सबसे बेहतरीन नर्सरी है और उसने कैसे सप्लाई किया आप देख लो. ये एंग्विश जो है ना मेरे अंदर की, ये एंग्विश ऐसे लिए है, पीपल आर देयर लाइक वी हु आर रेडी टू बाय, वी आर नो वेयर टू गो, हम कहीं और से नहीं बाय कर सकते, हमारे लिए सिर्फ आप लोग ही हो. पीपल हु आर मेकिंग इन इंडिया अराउंड 6,000 to 7,000 नर्सरीज, आप ही दाता लोग, आपके बिना कोई और है नहीं. आप अगर नहीं बदलोगे तो हमारी एक्सपेक्टेशन बढ़ती जाएगी. वी विल टेंड, अगर किसके पास बहुत अच्छा पैसा है तो यू विल लूज दैट 100, 200, 500 crore ऑफ बिजनेस टू समवन एल्स, बिकॉज आई हैव नो अदर वे, आई हैव टू बाय बिकॉज दीज आर स्टैंडर्ड स्पेसिफिकेशन. व्हेन वी आर डूइंग इन एस्पिरेशनल प्लेसेस लाइक एयरपोर्ट्स और इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट और मास्टर प्लान्स, वी नीड टू अडहेयर टू दीज थिंग. सो दीज आर एसेंशियल. Start now, you will reap after next 5 years, you will remember my name, whether I was correct or not. It is not me who's defining anything, it is defined by the world, it is defined by the business of nursery. So it is very essential you guys should know in terms of diameter, minimum depth, minimum volume. See, plant, kabhi kabar to upar ki volume, plant ka size shape alag hai, wo to chhod do. How do I buy it? At times I buy on a cubic inch of what they are filling as a material. So that also determines every root ball ke hisab se, everything is clear cut defined. Aap agar dekhte ho, caliper agar 4.5 inch ki hai to 4 foot ki hogi jhad. It is standard. I mean, mere bolne se kuch nahi, I'll show you the pictures of individual nurseries which are visited worldwide. Agar ye bolte hai to wo milta hai. मेरी चेहरा नहीं चाहिए मुझे, उनका पैसा नहीं पकड़ना है, पैसा तो मैं फूल देता हूँ. जो प्रॉमिस करते हैं उससे ज्यादा डिलीवर देते हैं. सॉरी, समबडी हु इज नॉट एबल टू फॉलो द हिंदी, वॉट एवर दे प्रॉमिस इन देयर स्टैंडर्ड्स आर डिलीवर्ड मच मोर देन व्हाट इज रिटन. दैट इज नॉट द केस इन इंडिया, आई एम वेरी सॉरी. लास्ट 25 इयर्स में शायद 3-4 लोग ही है जिनको मैं आंख बंद करके काम दे सकता हूँ, बाकी सबके पास तो झगड़ा तो होता ही है आप लोगों के साथ. सो वॉट मेक्स अ डिफरेंस हियर इज यू नीड टू adhere to standards. If someone is asking something on online, what you have written in your specification, you must make sure that you deliver much better than what is expected. There is the chance where the relationship start building with the people who give the best material. Well, what we call multi-stem, what we call clump, what we call shrub, all standards are clear cut defined from the root ball to the pot size to the caliper of the tree and the branches of the tree. I have attached this सबसे छोटा सा काम नर्सरी मैन के लिए क्या होता है, प्रोपगेशन. छोटी सी प्रोपगेशन जो आप कर रहे हो उसके लिए भी क्लियर कट डेफिनेशन है आपको तो. मैं भी ये डिग्री में सीख लिया, डिग्री में तो मैं देखा था, मुझे कभी किसी ने पढ़ाया नहीं. मैं यूनिवर्सिटीज को अभी भी, आई ऑलवेज आस्क यूनिवर्सिटीज टू इंक्लूड दिस इन द करिकुलम, सो दैट द नेक्स्ट जनरेशन हु आर गोइंग टू कम, एटलीस्ट दे कम विद द आइडिया ऑफ व्हाट आर स्टैंडर्ड्स, व्हाई वी नीड टू डू इट, what is the importance of those standards, what is the implications in terms of a business perspective. These are all clear cut defined when you look at 3 year ka plant, 1 year ka cutting bench, transplant agar aap karte ho to kaise hoga, ye sab defined hai US based, US code mein. clear cut definition is also there in terms of US. It is a this is BS standard. These are British standards. What do they give? They also give one step further from US standard in terms of how do you handle when it's an export package. What is the packaging standard for smallest of the small sapling to the largest of the full grown tree, which is 50-year, 100-year old, 500-year old, 1,200-year old trees are sold. I mean, it's not a joke. People buy that. There is a business. People are buying from world over. We are not thinking in that direction. That is the only thing what I can say. How do you dispatch a material from your nursery to the place, which whether it is an airport or a seaport or any other port, how it is dispatched? That definitions are clearly written. What are the damages? What damages you are responsible? What damages the insuring companies are responsible? Insurance is one more factor which do play a large role in terms of exporting and importing of plant. What in terms of what you also need to look in this website is in terms of how do you prepare for a season? When you want to export from India, you are having a rainy season right now. But that may not be the case while you are exporting it to many other nations. The season might be different there. You need to know what season you are exporting. How are you unloading there? What is the temporary storage facility? Whether it is controlled, whether it is open. What is the ground preparation those people have there? You need to handhold when you look at a larger perspective. How are they going to plant? And what is your recommendation in terms of aapne jo produce ke, whatever you have produced, you are responsible for it. That is what the standards say. When it comes to the export worldwide, there are two things what you need to make sure is the phytosanitary certificate, phytosanitization. Each and every country has its own phytosanitization in terms of what are the criteria. Basically, this is to avoid the transport of pests and diseases between the countries. This you need to know in terms of plant, what pest, what disease, what is being taken care of. There are particular crops which are restricted. In India, you may not be able to find these data properly defined. The recommendation what I make you guys is to refer these standards what is set by importing and exporting standards set by Singapore, because they are quite relevant. It's an hybrid system. Hybrids are always successful. In terms of what is the risk in terms of koi agar aap business karte ho, so you also need to know in terms of what is your risk, how do you mitigate that risk. Basically, it's again start with pest and the end supply, how it reaches to the end supply. That is clearly defined with the flow chart. What happens? What is the sequence? What is the method statement? How do the things happen? Sequence by sequence is clearly defined. In terms of where else you can do it. In terms of global standards, there is an agency called as Good Agricultural Practices Agency. Aap agar khane peene ki cheez bech rahe ho ya aap agar plant bech rahe ho, there is a clear cut definitions. You can also, you know, as an individual, as a firm, as a group, as a consortium, aap agar gajrola mein baithe ho, if you are part of a gajrola, a small committee can come in picture. The whole that committee get registered into a GPS GAP standards. If tenders floated or somebody wants to export to GAP associated countries, there are 135 countries which buy GAP standard materials. It is not a small game. 135 countries, and they are all large countries, the big buyers and the big money. So you can actually, as an individual, as a firm, as a group, you get associated with this. They will define, they will train you, they will make sure that their requirements are fulfilled at your end by training. What else? Where do you look for more information? You should look information in terms of your large tree exporter or a plant producer. There is an agency called as IPPS. It's a big group of like-minded people who it's a global network of professionals. They are interested in plant production. They give their research material. They educate you in terms of knowledge, skill, productivity, professionalism. Nearly 1,600 members all over the globe. It's one good opportunity. Whoever has a large interest in terms of as a business, you guys can look into it. the best country, nearly $50 billion worth transaction per annum. Our contribution, zero. I mean, 150 crore population, 6,000 या 60,000 नर्सरियां, हम एक्सपोर्ट में जीरो है अमेरिका को बेचने में. $60 billion industry. It's a great loss for us because we are not preparing, we are not ready to accept the thing, we are not ready to take the thing. Hope, but after listening to me, at least few of you will understand opportunities. Don't look at why we should do it. It is in terms of opportunities. एक रुपए यहाँ बेच रहे हो, वही एक रुपए वहां बेचो, 70 रुपए मिलेगा आप. What you need to look here is their standards for containers, their standards in terms of plant material, their standards in terms of operating procedures. How do you operate? Operating procedures also clearly defined. Yes, this is our greatest agency in India. The irony is, नर्सरी के बारे में एन भी नहीं लिखा है कहीं पे. नेशनल हॉर्टिकल्चर बोर्ड में दो चार जो 1980s 1990s के जो पेपर्स है उतना ही है. It is left to all of us to start defining and making sure that we are considered as a serious industry. For them, in terms of horticulture, we are all just part of the bit of horticulture. आप अगर अपीडा का कोई भी अपीडा देखो या नेशनल हॉर्टिकल्चर बोर्ड देखो या एग्रीकल्चर यूनिवर्सिटीज के पोर्टल देखो या कोई भी बैंक के पोर्टल देखो, उनके लिए सिर्फ क्रॉप्स ही बिजनेस है बिकॉज वी नेवर पोर्ट्रेड आवरसेल्फ एज अ पोटेंशियल बिजनेस स्टैंडर्ड. Why India, why I am stressing so much is, यार भारत देश में क्या नहीं, हिमालय से लेके राजस्थान की डेजर्ट से लेके सी कोस्ट, ईस्ट वेस्ट, ओल्डेस्ट फॉरेस्ट इन द वर्ल्ड, नियरली एवरी स्पीशीज ऑफ प्लांट वॉट यू सी ऑन द अर्थ कैन ग्रो हियर. मैंने -40 से लेके +48 degrees, इतना वेरिएशन कौन से कंट्री में है? कहीं नहीं है. लैथविया, लिथुएनिया, बेल्जियम जैसी छोटी छोटी कंट्री जो हमारी गली से भी छोटे है, they are exporting in billions. We need to change. Climate is one advantage. Agroclimatic zones is one advantage. You know, we have so much of potential in terms of value, growth potential, return on investment, status, in terms of biological, not only biological, in terms of every value, emotional trait we have for internal market as well as external market. We also have हर 16 किलोमीटर पे हर एक रिलीजन लैंग्वेज रहन सहन चेंज होती है. इट्स अ मार्केटिंग पोटेंशियल फॉर अस. हम सिर्फ बिजनेस वाले हैं, हम सिर्फ झाड़ वाले हैं, हमारे लिए कोई जात पात कोई और चीज है नहीं. मेक श्योर दैट एवरी ह्यूमन बींग इज अ पोटेंशियल कस्टमर फॉर अस. फ्रॉम अ कस्टमर परस्पेक्टिव, एवरी प्लांट स्पीशीज, देर आर 24 वेरियंट्स इन अशोका, यू नो 24 डिफरेंट पोटेंशियल. Who sells Ashoka worldwide? Height, it's an Indian plant. Everything is exported either from China or from Thailand, to some extent from Cambodia. The yellow ones and the red ones comes from Cambodia and Malaysia. India, शायद एक या दो vendor, दो container या 10 container, उससे ज़्यादा क्या बेच सकते हैं? मैंने है ही नहीं हमारे पास. What do you sell me? You sell me a 4-inch, 6-inch, 4 plant, 8 plant. My requirement per pallet is nearly around 200 to 400 number of each tree. What I get, agar 400 tree mujhe ek hi jagah, ek size, ek shape dhoondna hai, to ek bhi baal nahi bachegi sar pe. That is the reality. How do they sell other material? Look at this very carefully. Saraka Ashoka sold as a supplement, sold by an Indian, American Indian company selling an Indian product, selling an American price, an Indian product. We are not participating in this. And even if we participate, we are very, very nascent. How well? Yes, going ahead, wellness will be the first and foremost thing as a business opportunity for all of us. Whatever it makes us wellness, we will all be attracted to it, whether it is your, you can sell plants based on all these things. The great books and texts are available. Just Google down, or if someone needs, you can actually ask me. I can help you out with how do you put it across. You know, blood circulation, digestive system, nervous system, heart, brain, hair, beauty, you name it. For everything, there is a defined plant and plantation in the text. You can grow and sell only on that context also. The potential plants, I believe, you to read a lot of potential in terms of their ornamental value, in terms of medicinal value, in terms of fragrance, in terms of their beauty. These are all endless. In terms of horticulture, in terms of landscape, there are many things I will leave. Majorly, what you need to concentrate as a business, even if you're doing a vertical garden, you also need to look at where do you want to supply. Vertical gardens are integral part of infrastructure development and airports. The major development here, I'll tell you, around a $60 billion worth of industry airports in next 5 years, 10%, $6 billion. हम सब लोग मालामाल हो सकते हैं. इन द सेंस मैं नहीं, मेरे लिए आप प्लांट दोगे, मैं अच्छी तरह से प्रोजेक्ट बना पाऊंगा. आप सब लोग ये बिजनेस अपॉर्चुनिटीज को कैप्चर करके या कैपिटलाइज करके यू कैन अर्न मोर मनी इन नेक्स्ट 5 to 10 year साइकिल. जस्ट आई थिंक लास्ट हफ्ता ही दिल्ली का नया पार्लियामेंट बनने का टेंडर खुली है. 680 करोड़ मिनिमम, बेर मिनिमम 4%. कैन यू इमेजिन 32-35 करोड़ लैंडस्केप कहीं नहीं गया, उसका 10% 3-4 करोड़ का वर्टिकल वॉल आएगी, बिलीव मी, बिकॉज इट्स अ ट्रेंड. पब्लिक गार्डन्स, स्मार्ट सिटीज, पार्क्स एंड रिक्रिएशन, थेरापेटिक यूसेजेस, लॉन इंडस्ट्री. इंडिया में बहुत बड़ा नेसेंट इंडस्ट्री है ये. 4 या 5 लोग है जो मन में आए वो बेचते हैं, 2-3 लोग है बहुत प्रोफेशनल्स है, बाकी सब लोग अगेन इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी राइट की बहुत बड़ी इशू है वहाँ पे. People buy seeds, sell in their own name. That is not correct. Irrigation industry still remains a big pain. Height, 150 crore population, इतने हजार करोड़ की business, एक Indian company ने हम अभी भी क्या बेच रहे? Rainbird, Indian नहीं है. और IPI, Indian नहीं है. Hunter, Indian नहीं है. बाकी जो Indian है, उनको हम trust नहीं करते. क्यों? क्योंकि again performance issue, after sales issue, they don't stand by their product. I don't want to name the companies. See, this is the pain. A very big industry, billions of dollars world mein, itna bada opportunity ka hai kya yaar, wo plastic ki cheeze thodi si aapki dimag, thodi si AI ka dimag utilize kar lo. Jo bhi main aaj yahan pe karodo dal ke banaya hua hai, usme koi 30 mark kangiri nahi hai. Only what you need to do is you need to make Indianize the product. You need to make Asianize the product. You need to look at countries where you can actually sell this technology in a very simpler way. You know how, I need to water at a height of 12 meters. How do I water it? It is impossible to water manually. I need to depend completely on AI-based solution. Solution which give me alarms on my cell, which actually operates on its own in terms of water, moisture content at the root zone, relative humidity at the root zone, plant requirement, all these things. Agar somebody puts forth as a collective package in terms of manufacturing, in terms of giving the technology, in terms of standing by the technology, it's a potential industry. Green wall, this is one of the biggest green wall producer in Holland. It's Mobile.
Yeah, well, we have pretty much a standard mix, which is doing nicely. Then we also have four projects.
They go by the product mix and the plant suitable for that product mix.
Now, if you're going to pre-grow these in your nursery, yes, you don't need these tables.
Yes,
you can make it a different way.
Yes, we can actually stake them.
You can stake them, make it better. But the reason why we have it here, because the whole nursery is designed for the aluminium tables.
Okay.
So also our pots, all our crops.
ये छोटी मेटी नर्सरी नहीं है, 10 किलोमीटर की नर्सरी है. 16,000 करोड़ का बिजनेस करते हो. कुल मिला के टोटल नर्सरी में 86 पीपल वर्क करते हैं. सिर्फ 86. Everything is mechanized.
Smart. The ones which are on the computer.
For the life which you grow.
Okay.
Everything is pre-grown, pre-supplied. They stand by their product, including the plant.
We're doing some tests. We're making cassettes pre-grown for shows.
Okay.
For shoots. This is a small cassette I showed.
Maybe I'll require another 15 minutes to rush through.
4-6 months old, high humidity for root cutting. This is ready with the roots.
Sir, apna question answer session ek
videos, but I will make sure that give me another 10 minutes because these are all very interesting stuff.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sure, sure, sir.
Working in two lanes. I mean, they fix it from the top temporarily. Yes.
And one more business idea, garden centers. अगर हर गांव में एक मेडिकल शॉप हो सकती है तो एक गार्डन सेंटर क्यों नहीं? अपने आप को पूछ के देख लो, बिजनेस की बहुत बड़ी अपॉर्चुनिटी है। यह धंधा चलेगी या नहीं चलेगी? हर गांव में प्लांट्स की तुलसी से लेके बड़ी ट्रीज हर एक को रिक्वायरमेंट है। सो ये बिजनेस चलती है, प्रेजेंटेबल करके आप बना सकते हो। दीज आर ऑल सम ऑफ द वर्ल्ड इंडस्ट्रीज। नाउ लेट मी कम टू क्विकली, आई विल टेक यू थ्रू अ वीडियो व्हाट आई कॉल इट एज अ one of the best nurseries I have seen in recent times. This is a very small town near Pisa. Ek business individual owner hai. Ye koi made up video nahi hai. This is an actual video shot on site. Choti si gaon, Bajgada jaisa jo gaon hai, Delhi ki Bajgada ho sakta hai ya aapki Bijwasin ho sakta hai. Ek choti si gaon ya Maharashtra ka Nasik se bhi chota galiyaron mein se ho sakta hai. या कर्नाटका का यू नो देवनहल्ली के आजू बाजू का छोटी सी गांव है। एक गांव टोटल बिजनेस सिर्फ नर्सरी। माने आप जमीन से देख के तो पागल ही हो जाओगे, ये आसमान से देख के ऐसी नर्सरी लगती है, ये कड़ियम में भी नहीं दिखता। आई मीन दैट इज माय आयरनी। माने 16,000-17,000 एक साथ इकट्ठे वहां नहीं दिखा सकते आप लोग। आई मीन जस्ट सीन दे सी देम, किसी और के लिए नहीं दिख। It is from a perspective, uniform standards, uniform material, same container, same plant growth media, rates are same wherever you visit. See, the major advantage is at any time, any number you can buy from one single source. I'll show with a close proximity how does these things look. Second, their major success is due to mechanization, very less manpower, very efficient manpower. Pot mixing dekh lo, you know. Pre-grown media, माने media पूरा ready रहता है, standard media which is acceptable to any standards of the world.
Peat moss and the khadi.
Majorly their usage is peat moss.
It's actually a pot filler. It's a pre-mixed material. Changing the pot size.
Use of large machinery. I'll share that video. See, 35 years back, I told you one story from a Belgium, a choti si gaon in Belgium. He is the buying his trees is a abhi aajkal it's a trend now. You know, if you buy from solitaire nurseries, is that it is actually a solitaire. they stand by their name. Whatever they produce, they produce the solitaire.
Might be small, but it's home to a company with big ambitions, born from a simple love of trees.
One single man can change the whole country.
Found its place in an increasingly urbanized world. Success for a business of this particular kind needs faith and patience. Time fueled the business, and 40 years later, solitaire trees have been embraced by cities throughout the world, from Dublin to Ankara and London to Tbilisi.
Sometimes we have a tree 35 years in the nursery.
Dick is the owner of the company.
And then it starts a new life on the new city on there. It starts again. But it's not only the tree that make a good atmosphere. No, together with all the other things, or maybe a building, and then the combination of the tree, maybe stones or other things, that all together make the new place for the tree special.
When Cole started the business in 1986, people were skeptical of his plans. But over the years, the company has nurtured valuable and lucrative relationships worldwide. Solitaire now comprises a square kilometer of 60,000 shrubs and trees, with 20 employees, including his wife, son-in-law, and daughter.
That was Belgium. This is mass production. पूरी स्टेट की स्टेट या आधी कंट्री ऐसा प्रोड्यूस करता है. दिस इज चाइना. आई मीन मेनी ऑफ माय यू माइट हैव ऑलरेडी सीन व्हेन इट कम्स टू बल्क बाइक. दैट वाज चाइना. दिस इज इंडिया. ही इज इंडियाज बेस्ट नर्सरी. आई डोंट वांट टू नेम हिम. ही गेव मी अ हार्ट अटैक. आई पेड हिम अ गुड सम. दिस इज हाउ यू गाइस सप्लाई मी. क्वाइट सैड. I have to take a lot of care. I have to nurture them again to bring back to them to a proper condition. This is where we lack in terms of trust, you know, in terms of how do we develop the relationship. Whether it is me, whether it is someone else who's sitting on this chair, everyone will have a same pain. You know, when we pay you, we expect some good material. We trust you. What we get delivered is this. This is not going to sustain for a long, long run. So whoever wants, whoever is there in the industry, I request you guys, whatever you say, ek inch thoda upar dena taake main aapko trust kar paun blindly. This is what is actually showcased and sold world over. I'll quickly rush through because I already overshoot the time. That's not correct. That was China and Taiwan and part of Thailand. This is all Europe, ranging from Portugal, Holland, Italy, and Spain. Look at all uniform size, uniform shape, ek jaisa, ek cheez, ek ke aap ek cheez pe aap haath rakho, aise 100 mil jayenge aapko, ek same standard pe. Ek hi crop, bougainvillea, kuch aur nahi bechta hai. Only he sells bougainvillea. He is expert in only 10 varieties. He doesn't sell anything else. If you want those 10 things, you are bound to go there because of his quality of material. In terms of business ideas and things, data will be shared to you. Individual crop wise also, we can actually sell the things. In terms of Indian business, in terms of infrastructure and airport is $60 billion industry. $60 billion government is going to spend that money. At least 4 se 5 takka is around hundreds of crores of business. It's just there in 5 years time you will see that. Many people are participating. Where you need to get in touch with me is you need to participate in the individual portals, whether it is Bangalore Airport or a Delhi Airport. Delhi Airport is also Terminal 1 is getting refurbished. Again, 100 crores aapka business aayega. Delhi mein dusra airport bhi aa raha, Jewar. Kam se kam 4 se 600 crore ki landscape ki business aayegi. Pune, Goa. गोवा में नया एयरपोर्ट आ रहा है. उसके बाद में बेंगलुरु में 3rd एयरपोर्ट प्लान्ड है, वो भी आ जाएगी. नियरली अदानी गॉट अराउंड 10 एयरपोर्ट्स. ऑल एयरपोर्ट्स आर गोइंग टू चेंज अगेन. एवरीवेयर वी आर गोइंग टू सेट अ स्टैंडर्ड बिकॉज एस्पिरेशनली एवरीवन वांट्स टू बिकम लाइक चांगी. सो बिजनेस तो आती रहेगी बट प्रोवाइडेड थोड़ी सी चेंज, थोड़ी सी नजाकत, थोड़ी सी यू नो चेंजिंग योर पर्सपेक्टिव, चेंजिंग द वे यू डिस्प्ले योर थिंग्स. Putting up the things in standards will help all of us. Every state has got one, at least one airport. So 28 से लेके 30 एयरपोर्ट्स आ रहे हैं वर्ल्ड वाइड, 3600 एयरपोर्ट आ रहे हैं. Somebody wants to export outside 3600 एयरपोर्ट्स. They are basically developed by the large conglomerates. Just Google down, you will get many of the airports which are getting developed in Philippines, US, UK, Red Sea. Red Sea itself has around 4 airports. Red Sea is in Saudi Arabia. They are good paymasters for a good product. They are very bad if you are supplying very badly. You will burn yourself. That's a difficulty. Where lies the success? Success lies with automation, whether it is your irrigation, whether it's fertigation, whether it's maintenance. बिना ऑटोमेशन के काम नहीं चलेगी. पेंडेमिक तो एक कोरोना आया, हम सब लोग को इतना पतला बना दिया. इमेजिन करो आगे जाते वक्त जिस ढंग से हम लोग जंगल काट रहे, जिस ढंग से हम लोग अर्बनाइजेशन होते जा रहे, ये कोरोना के ग्रैंडसन्स, कोरोना के ग्रेट ग्रैंडसन्स आएंगे तो क्या हालत रहेगा हम लोग का. सो ओनली फॉल बैक फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस इज ऑटोमेशन. ऑटोमेशन एज अ मेंटेनेंस, ऑटोमेशन इन टर्म्स ऑफ बिजनेस पर्सपेक्टिव यू कैन सी. अगला 20 अगला क्या है, व्हाट इज स्टोर्ड फॉर अस? इट इज स्टोर्ड फॉर अस इन टर्म्स ऑफ लॉट ऑफ बिजनेस आइडियाज, इन टर्म्स ऑफ फूड फॉरेस्ट. यू नो बाय 1940 बाय 2045 देयर इज अ रिपोर्ट व्हिच सेज दैट टिपिकल एग्रीकल्चर विल गो अवे, अर्बन फार्मिंग इज गोइंग टू कम. वी विल सी लॉट ऑफ अर्बन फार्मिंग, एवरी बिल्डिंग हैज इट्स ओन सस्टेनेबल फार्मिंग ऑन टॉप ऑफ इट. वी एंड यू नो people would like to sustain biodiversity, so a lot of things are going to come surrounding biodiversity. People will be there will be less chances in terms of these pandemics continue. We will become self-centric in terms of how do we do our own gardens in our balconies. They say by people tend to like the color blue. That is a scientific research, nothing from my end. So blue वैसा भी आगे चलने वाली कलर है, वेदर इट इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ प्लांट्स, इन टर्म्स ऑफ मटेरियल फिक्सिंग. तो ये एक अपॉर्चुनिटी है. बिफोर आई कंक्लूड, दिस इज अ वेग आइडिया विच इज नॉट कंसर्न टू एनीथिंग. जस्ट थिंक ओवर, आई मीन व्हाट अ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म विच वॉज कोरोना कैन बी अ बिजनेस अपॉर्चुनिटी इन फ्यूचर. एनी माइक्रोब,
right? So on your skin right now, on your face, you're part of the reason you have bad breath is because of microbes. You use deodorant because of microbes. And plants are just the same as people. So there's microbes that live on them, on their leaves, on their roots. They break down certain things for the plant. They provide certain nutrients or growth factors for the plant. Like in soybeans, for example, they even provide fertilizer for the plant. But a lot of your other crops, particularly our big food crops like corn, wheat, and rice, they don't have microbes that do this.
So most crops need artificial nitrogen fertilizer because there isn't enough nitrogen naturally existing in soils. Artificial fertilizers are incredibly important to feeding the global population. About 48% of the current population exists because of these artificial fertilizers. Nitrogen fertilizers are so interesting because they are not only this huge benefit to society, but they also come with these huge consequences to public health and the environment. When we apply fertilizers to crops, only about 50% of it makes it into the food that we eat, and the rest becomes an environmental pollutant.
What do we do about the problem with synthetic nitrogen fertilizers? If you banned it tomorrow, a large part of the world population would starve. So that's not a viable alternative. The purpose of JoinBio, the reason we're there, is to provide new, innovative, sustainable solutions to growers. Our specific approach is to use beneficial microbes and engineer them to address specific challenges or specific problems that the grower has. If you go look at soybeans,
I would like to end here. Microbes as a future. That's a big idea for us in terms of less consumption, more production. Thank you very much, INA. Thank you very much, everyone. I'm sorry I overshoot by 21 minutes. I'm so sorry. I would like to take the questions if someone has. Think big, things will happen.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Desai sir, for giving a very inspiring speech. I always say ki Desai sir jab bolte tab chetna jag uthti hai, and isme koi sandeh nahi hai. आपने जो आज स्पीच दिया है उसमें प्रेजेंटेशन से मुझे ऐसे लगता है कि दो हमारे में से 5-6 लोग तो जरूर इंस्पायर होंगे, एंड वी विल फोकस ऑन द गुड क्वालिटी पैरामीटर्स एंड वी विल गो फॉरवर्ड. एंड इसमें इंडियन नर्सरी एसोसिएशन को जो भी इनिशिएटिव लेना है, तो मुकुल त्यागी साहब भी आज साथ में है, तो 100% वी विल गो फॉरवर्ड एंड हम इसमें जरूर अच्छे से काम करने करेंगे और करके ही दिखाएंगे. सो व्हाट एवर द यू हैव कंक्लूडेड विद द थिंक बिग, वी विल गो द थिंक बिग 100% विद प्रैक्टिकल अप्रोच. थैंक यू वेरी मच देसाई सर फॉर गिविंग ए
वेरी
नॉलेजेबल एंड इंस्पायरिंग स्पीच. सो आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट, दोज हु हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस प्लीज गो अहेड. एनीबडी हैज क्वेश्चन?
Sir, I need the videos of these both lectures.
Sir, you will get all the videos from INA. So, you will get all the presentation and these things. If you have any question, you please go ahead.
Please ask the questions because शायद हम लोग आपस में एक दूसरे को मिलने के लिए थोड़ा सा मुश्किल रहेगा. So, please ask as many questions as possible to Pradeep. He is legendary. Even though he looks very humble, don't go by his looks. He's actually walking university in terms of green walls and green things structured green walls.
Very true sir. Any question from participants?
Excuse me.
Yeah madam, Suruchi madam, please go ahead.
Right. Sir, first of all, I would really like to thank you because I was looking for something like that only. Let me introduce myself. This is Dr. Suruchi and my PhD is on nutritional use of medicinal plants.
Amazing.
Depending on this, the area for the study was Melghat region, which is on the border of Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh. So after seeing your lecture, I am really impressed and I would like to know more about it. I'm from the middle class family particularly, and I would like to know that what I can do in this field, particularly for the nutritional use, because I am a dietitian, I am a nutritionist, and I would like to go for some kinds of thing like you showed the slide, such as medicinal use for digestive system. So this only was my part of study. I have researched for 75 medicinal plants, including nervous system, digestive system, and the confirmation of these medicinal plants from Ayurvedic literature. Like Bhrigu Samhita and Dravya Guna Vijnan. So I would really like to know some more which I can do on my own self, and then I'll let it grow like the ideas you have given to me. So from where to start is my question to you.
This is sir.
Namaste. सबसे पहले तो आप एक blog चालू कर लो.
जी.
आपकी blog चालू करो. अगर कोई medicinal plant के लिए कोई भी search करता है ना, I should always end up hitting your blog. आप अपने 10 लोगों को बोलो कि आपकी जो ब्लॉग है उस पर क्लिक करने के लिए. हाउ डज दिस ऑपरेट इन टर्म्स ऑफ गूगल? नो, वी ऑलवेज गेट द सेम इंफॉर्मेशन व्हाट वी सीक फॉर. हर बार आप कुछ खोल के रखो, आपको वही इंफॉर्मेशन पॉपअप होते रहेगा. आपको क्या चाहिए? आपसे सबसे बड़ा इंफॉर्मेशन तो हमें ये चाहिए, आप सबसे पहले सबको ये बता दो कि क्या क्या प्लांट है, क्या क्या पोटेंशियल है. आप एक पैनलिस्ट बन सकते हो. आप इमेजिन कर लो, आपकी पीएचडी हो चुकी है उसमें. यू नो, यू आर अ ग्रेट रिसोर्स फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस एज अ नर्सरी मैन. आप पुट अप करो कि किस प्लांट किस ढंग से कैसे यूज किया जाता है. एंड आप एक नारी होने की वजह से मैं ये भी एक्सपेक्ट करूंगा कि मुझे उससे चटनी कैसे बनना है, उससे कैसे यूटिलाइज कर पाऊंगा ऑन माई डे टू डे यूसेज. मैं एक नॉर्मल मैन हूँ. आप बिजनेस की परस्पेक्टिव से नहीं सोच रहे हो. आप अगर सब लोग को ज्ञान देना चाहते हो तो मेक इट वेरी सिंपल पैलेटेबल इजी, सो दैट वी ऑल गेन आउट ऑफ योर नॉलेज एंड इट बिकम्स पार्ट ऑफ अ नर्सरी मैन सेल्स फैक्टर.
Wonderful, sir. It's really, really wonderful to how to start is a एक बहुत बड़ा सवाल होता है ये normal person के लिए कि मैं start कहाँ से करूँ. Knowledge तो मुझे बहुत मिल गया लेकिन शुरू कहाँ से करूँ. तो आपने
yes madam, we will have the more questions. Sorry to interrupt you, but we have more questions. So anybody has any question?
Right. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Any more question from?
So soft video.
हेलो
हेलो सर.
हाँ जी बोलिए सर, आपका क्वेश्चन बोलिए.
हेलो.
हाँ बोलिए सर, आपका क्वेश्चन बोलिए आप.
हाँ सर, मैं ये कह रहा था अभी आपने जो सर ने प्रथम मूर्ति से सर ने वो वीडियो बताया था, वो कहाँ का था जहाँ पूरी फार्मिंग हो रही थी, वो प्लांटेशन की हो रखी थी?
एक्चुअली मैंने तीन चार जगह पे आपको दिखाया था, आप अगर ग्रीन वॉल इंडस्ट्री देख रहे हो तो
नजर में पूरा वो उसे बड़ा आपने बताया था, वो
स्पेन की थी, एक इटली की थी और एक स्पेन की थी और एक बेल्जियम का था, वो इंडिविजुअल फार्मर जो था बेल्जियम का था।
अच्छा, अपने इंडिया में तो कैडमियम ही है ना सर सबसे बड़ा?
कैडमियम क्वांटम है, कैडमियम में इस ढंग से नहीं है, कैडमियम इज अ बिजनेस सेंटर, वो मैं कभी उसको ये नहीं बोल पाऊंगा कि इंटरनेशनल स्टैंडर्ड की कोई नर्सरी है वहां पे। दिल्ली में बहुत सारे लोग अभी शुरू किया है, दिल्ली में फॉर पीपल इन देयर ऑनेस्ट एफर्ट टू मेक दैट इंटरनेशनल स्टैंडर्ड।
ठीक है सर, बहुत अच्छा लगा आपसे मिलके, ज्वाइन करके बहुत अच्छा लगा। मेरा नर्सरी का काम है, मेरा लैंडस्केपिंग और गार्डन डेवलपमेंट का काम है।
ऑल द बेस्ट।
अभी सब बढ़िया, जैसे देसी सामने बढ़े ना तो इसी वजह से स्टैंडर्ड से काम करना है हम सब लोगों को। तो आई थिंक एनी मोर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम पार्टिसिपेंट्स?
सर आई नीड टू नो अबाउट द न्यूट्रिएंट कॉम्बिनेशन फॉर द वर्टिकल वॉल्स।
सर बारपांडे सर, दिस क्वेश्चन इज फॉर यू बारपांडे सर।
सी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हमें ग्रीन वॉल बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ना नहीं चाहिए, उसको आप नाइट्रोजन ज्यादा देके बढ़ाओगे तो उतने बार ऊपर चढ़ के काटना पड़ेगा। तो यू हैव टू गिव न्यूट्रिशंस स्पेरिंगली। हम एक आसान तरीका करते हैं, बसाकोट या स्लो रिलीज फर्टिलाइजर जो है उसको अप्लाई करते हैं, वो स्लोली रिलीज होता रहता है और रिपीटेटिवली फर्टिगेशन न्यूट्रिएंट्स देने का काम करना कम पड़ता है। स्टैंडर्ड जो है 19-19-19 दैट यू कैन गिव, एंड यू कैन गिव फ्यू माइक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट्स। You can also use humic acid. That's all. We don't give a lot of nutrients.
Sir, just, as I am an organic specialist, so I think that is there any research on the organic inputs only? Because I am also medicinal plants, working on the medicinal plant or the food items. So if we are going for a vertical garden for the greens of the food.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely. See, one has to, depending on the climatic conditions, if you use right plant in the right light intensity and the right media, then the probability of getting diseases is very low. And if diseases are not much alarming, then you can definitely depend on organic materials. But there comes a time when diseases or pests are very strong and a lot of they appear in very large quantity. In that case, you may have to use some chemicals or different medicines for that.
Okay, yes, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. I think time is much more now, so we will conclude here. I think all the questions are over. Now I request INA secretary. Yes, sir.
I have one question. We are trying to design a media for vegetables. Means.
Doctor, sir, boliye. Doctor, Vakte, sir, please continue.
He has a network problem, it seems.
Yeah.
Hello.
Doctor, sir.
We are going for vermicompost and all these organic nutrient suppliers. And even we are going for basakot based also. So I would like to ask Barpandi sir, whether there will be anything this we will need to certify it as organic or so. This basakot will be a problem?
I think you have to speak to Mahesh Damodare for this. He will be able to guide. Okay.
Okay.
And most importantly, since you are doing it for not vertical gardening, you can definitely use a biodegradable material. Even young biomass, you can definitely use, and that will not be a problem. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thanks.
So I request Mukul Tyagi sir, Secretary INA, to give a vote of thanks to all the our speakers and participants. So over to you, Mukul Tyagi sir.
धन्यवाद सचिन जी. आज के वेबिनार में उपस्थित सभी व्यूअर्स का और सभी स्पीकर्स का मैं बहुत धन्यवाद करता हूँ. आज मैं गर्व का विषय है हमारे लिए कि हमारे जो वेबिनार में आज मेन स्पीकर रहे हमारे प्रदीप बारपंडे जी, जो लैंडस्केपिंग के क्षेत्र में न केवल इंडिया बल्कि अब्रॉड में इनका नाम है. बहुत अच्छा लगा, उन्होंने अपने अनुभव और उनका सहयोग में मिलता रहा है पहले भी, और बहुत सुंदर उनका प्रेजेंटेशन रहा. प्रसन्ना मूर्ति जी के बारे में क्या कहूँ, उनको बहुत बहुत नॉलेज है, बहुत ब्रॉड उनको नॉलेज है, और उनके ज्ञान को हम चाहे 10 मिनट में, 20 मिनट में, एक घंटे में नहीं समेट सकते, तो बहुत उन्हें विस्तार से उन्होंने हमें गाइड किया है, और मैं उनका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद अदा करता हूँ. सचिन ब्रह्मंकर जी हमारे जो महाराष्ट्र चैप्टर के जनरल सेक्रेटरी हैं और वेबिनार के हमारे बहुत ही इनके फ्रेंड है सारा, बहुत अच्छा. मैं इनको धन्यवाद अदा करूंगा कि इतने अच्छे स्पीकर्स ज्ञान विद्वान लोग हमारे बीच में आप प्रस्तुत करते हैं स्पीकर के रूप में. मंजीत पिशाल जी जो टेक्निकल हमारा सारा देखते हैं, उनको बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद करूंगा. और हमारे प्रेसिडेंट मिस्टर वाई पी सिंह जी का भी धन्यवाद कि उनके नए नए विचार, नए नए सोच से आई एन ए आगे बढ़ रहा है. और सभी व्यूअर्स का मैं धन्यवाद अदा करूंगा कि उन्होंने अपना कीमती समय दिया, हमारे बीच सहयोग रखा, और उम्मीद करता हूँ कि आगे भी आपका सहयोग जारी रहेगा. ये हमारी जो सीरीज है वेबिनार वाली जो पेंडेमिक में शुरू हुई थी, और अब आगे चूंकि मांग पे इसकी निरंतर मांग जारी है और उसको हम जारी रखे हुए हैं, आपका सहयोग इसी तरह बना रहेगा. बारपंडे जी का, प्रसन्ना मूर्ति जी का और सभी का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू बारपंडे सर. थैंक यू देसाई सर. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू.
Thank you.